the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Ocala Radio, WOCA.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. Peter J. McAllister. He's a professor of neurology at Yale University School of Medicine, coming up to speak to us about treatment options that can help those with chronic migraines.
Susanna DeBaca is the vice president of Well Strategies. She'll be speaking about the new City Pulse Index Survey.
And then News Bites. We take the hottest, freshest news right off the press, and we deliver it to you bite-sized.
Have all of your gardening questions answered by Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin on You've Got a Garden.
And then Tamiko Richardson will be on with us. She is a consultant to Team Disney, coming out to speak about a book called Get a Clue.
And then Joe Reichel from Damage Control will be answering all of your disaster restoration questions.
And Tim Prosh will be with us. He writes for the Wall Street Journal. He's got a book. It's called The Other Talk.
C. William Jones is the chairman of ProtectSeniors.org. He'll be speaking about IBM's cancellation of earned retirement health care benefits.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Sign up for this year's Marion County Heart Walk and be part of a local movement that's helping others live longer, healthier lives. Join Chairman Dr. Jim Henningsen and walk with us on Saturday, October 5th at Baseline Road Trailhead. It's a free event promoting physical activity and heart-healthy living. To find out how you can help the fight against the number one killer of all Americans, visit us online at marionheartwalk.org.
Howdy folks, RL here to invite you to Dairy Queen for a great new meal. Dairy Queen's now serving three different $5 meals. Hot dogs with chili, cheese, slaw, whatever. Quarter pound with cheese, loaded up any way you like it. Solid filet chicken tenders. And each meal comes with fries, a drink, and a sundae for only $5. You got that right. Nobody beats that deal. A great value and a great meal. So come on down to Dairy Queen at Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Hey, welcome back to Voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin. Those of you who have listened to this show and follow this show are very aware of how strongly I feel and how deep my feelings are about Silver Springs, about saving it, refurbishing it, returning it to the people. Over the weekend, the news comes that the Silver Springs deal is done, more or less. The checklist that many of us had for the Springs was like this. Number one, beginning clearing up and cleaning up the springs and the pollution. Happy to report that is in progress. Number two, find a new tenant. Palace is out. That's done. Number three, tearing down the walls around the spring so we can once again return to the picnic grounds or walk along the sidewalk next to the springs and enjoy the beauty of the place. The walls, I understand, have come down. Finally, number four, finding local people to run the concessions. That's the question that was answered on Saturday. A story by Bill Thompson in the Star Banner. Sort of. More on that in just a moment. I've followed this closely. I belong to a group called Save Silver Springs. It was a group without an agenda per se. Nobody had any thoughts about trying to take over the Springs. There was a plan that was drafted, and I don't know if it was ever offered to somebody, which was, I thought, pretty sound, but, you know, there are other plans out there. It never went public, by the way. And I'm not going to sit here and go through the litany of ups and downs that we've all been going through for this last 3 years during this process, but suffice to say, at least for the moment, we do have some kind of resolution. And we're very happy we have accomplished some, and I say some, of our key goals. Meanwhile, I remain ignorant about the details, as apparently most of you do too, and especially our public officials. Either that or they develop a bad case of lockjaw because none of them want to talk about it, apparently. I endeavor to get folks on this show to do this, to talk about it, and maybe explain what the plan is. The deal is done now, and Joel Wiesner of What's Up Ocala and Silver Springs Management, along with Bobby Genovese, will run this show. I do not know Joel Wiesner. I know people who know Joel Wiesner. I've spoken by Joel Wiesner on the phone. I've actually had him text me back and forth. And I hope to have a chance to do that soon. He's 26, I understand. And he's the man running the operation. And Mr. Genovese, owner of BG Capital Group out of the Bahamas, is the investor and has the money. I don't know how much other money is involved in this. I don't know the details. Hopefully the state will tell us. They'll have to by law at some point because the Sunshine Law. But I'm just really disappointed in the process of how business is done. The unwillingness of the parties to come out in the open, discuss the events as they unfolded, and even though the meetings were generally good, the real information never came out. I say we simply must demand better from our state and local officials. And I guess our lack of intensity on our end to demand that we want to know. So who's Joel Wiesner and what do we know about him? So far, unable to get him on this program. Again, on his Facebook page, I've mentioned I'd like to get him on the show. I'd like to have him explain his plan, who he is, how he's going to help the state shape the future of the Springs. I went into his LinkedIn site, and I just saw that Joel Wiesner, publishing and event marketing, Ocala, Florida, area event services, What's Up Ocala Magazine and Media, education, Valencia Community College, et cetera, et cetera. Short of that, he had as the people who were influencers in his life, he mentioned Richard Branson, founder of Virgin Airlines, Airways, Deepak Chopra, of course we know who he is, and Arianna Huffington, who, of course, the founder of the HuffPost. The story in the Star Banner says that Wiesner made an original bid to the DEP, and he had featured three events ready to go, including Kid Fetty, the Family Oriented Outdoor and Musical Festival, a fashion show that promote local clothing designers, and the Nature County Film Fest School, which will be a series of events to draw national film production companies to the Springs. There is already a Silver Springs Festival, by the way, film festival in place, which is separate from that. But Wiesner explained some of those things, and according to the story again, the state came back to Joel Wiesner and said, how about taking more? Apparently nobody else wanted it, and so he did. So on that count, bully for Joel Wiesner. Good for you for stepping up, which is what we need in this county, people to step up. I hope they're in place as a plan and organization to handle this. I wish them all the best. But my thoughts about this, I'm happy we've resolved some of the issues about Silver Springs. I remain bullish on Silver Springs. I just hope that the news that comes next will answer some of my remaining questions. We shall see. Coming up in just a moment, we'll have our tweets and quotes. A little levity today on kind of a serious day. Sports Hour will discuss was pathetically boring football weekend, which is never good. We earlier in the first hour, we talked about the Emmys, if you watched them last night. Very surprised a lot of people were about Jeff Daniels, who plays the anchor in Newsroom. I can't say he was better necessarily than the others because he was up some great competition. I've got to give a plug for my man, Jeff Daniels. I'm a fan of Newsroom. I started watching it from the beginning. I took HBO primarily because it was on the network, and I was a little disappointed the first couple of shows, and by the second season and by the eighth show, it really grew on me. And I got to tell you that if you think it's easy to, you got to be an anchorman to play an anchorman, and he did a heck of a job. My thoughts were, heck, he could be an anchorman, and I wound up really liking the show. A lot of people were shocked. I was not shocked. I was surprised, and so was he, because the competition was so strong. But I think Newsroom deserved a little accolade, and they got it there. So, and, of course, we all talked about Merritt Weaver, who's now the new hero of the Emmys for her short acceptance speech, which Neil Patrick Harris called the greatest acceptance speech ever. She freaked out and said, I got to go. Goodbye. And good for her.
JJ says that's the best acceptance speech he's ever heard as well.
Well, I mean, so did Neil Patrick Harris.
I cannot stand acceptance speeches.
Yeah, well.
Some of them are really funny. Some people just have good personality, or funny personalities. They're charismatic up there. And they just know how to talk to a crowd. But then there's those actors that get up there. And usually it's like the technical people that win at the Oscars that are horrible. That have no personality.
They shouldn't even
at
be
all.
Up there.
Exactly. And they have a huge list, and nobody really cares, but they have to have their, you know, 5 seconds of fame.
The ones I hate is the stars that get up there, and instead of saying, thanks to my agent, or, you know, this is a great medium, thanks and everything, they say, let me tell you what I think about what's going on in the world right now, and do some political statement.
Kenya. Oh, speaking of
Sean
Kenya,
Penn's
by the way.
Famous for doing that.
Speaking of Kenya, by the way, breaking news. Kenyan forces have officially secured the upscale shopping mall, killing 3 suspected terrorists and promising to, quote, punish any others they encounter. So, looks like they sort of have things under control over there.
Yeah, I said earlier the news that I heard on Huckabee's show, Governor Huckabee's show, that they kidnapped people and said if you can recite the Muslim prayer, we'll let you live. And
or there are some people where they asked if they could name Muhammad's mother's name.
Yeah,
and
Esther.
Yeah, and basically they just took out most of the white-looking people, which makes sense, I guess. People connected with Al-Qaeda, their Somalian terrorist group. So nothing surprises me.
We're not really aware of the holy war that goes on over there. I mean,
not at all.
We're totally tuned out, so. I know that people have been talking about what's happened in Somalia a long time ago and places like that.
I just choose not to go places like that.
I think that's good advice, JJ.
Anywhere that
a good travel agent.
Anywhere that religious zealots, uneducated, with AK-47s walking around, I try to stay away from.
Yeah.
But back to the Emmys a second. What's the part you like to see out, and what would you like to see? And there are some speeches that need to be a little longer. I mean, there's just some that they didn't cut off, but I understand the rules. I'm wondering why they didn't have any sports Emmys. You know, why don't they have a couple of best sports show and best announcer?
They give those away.
I know.
They give those away early without.
I don't care. I'm saying, why are they not more important than technical, you know, whatever, and so and so?
Yeah, why do I need to know who won best makeup when I want to know that Bob Costas beat out Dan Patrick again? That's what I want to know.
What's the most watched show of the year? Super Bowl. I mean, after all, let's be honest.
And why doesn't the director of the Super Bowl win? You see all these. Directors of variety shows and TV specials. Why isn't the Super Bowl ever nominated?
They're going to have one category. Just say, okay, we're going to have best program, best producer, and best announcer. You know, and boom, 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 let it happen. I mean, there's some stuff they could do without on the Emmys. And you don't need 2.5 hours or whatever it was to do all
I mean,
that.
You got your Emmy in the mail.
I got it sent to me by UPS.
Right. Yeah. They do. You weren't even at the Emmys. They just sent you and said, here, buddy, you, by being a producer on the show, you won this.
Yeah, I was totally shocked, by the way. And it wasn't just the show that won the Emmy. I happened to be on it. I just got lucky. But the point is that they ought to have some of the highest paid people in television are sports people. But if you could take one thing out, what would you take out?
If I could take one thing out of the Emmys, what would I take out?
Yeah.
I would take out the best, you know, the best directed television
all right, here's what
variety show or something. Yeah. It's you know, because it's always the 97th Academy Awards, right, we'll the 26th Tony Awards.
Let's look at the list during the break and say, here's what we can do without, because I kind of caught you cold there. So we'll look at it, come back and say, these are the things you could take out of the Emmys and add sports or something in it. You know, they listen to our program in New York. They might go for this. You never know.
They may. We're well listened to up in the New York tri-state area.
Let's take a break. And we'll come back and we'll tell you about it right here on The Voice of God. Hello up there in New York.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Recently, I had a great conversation with General Manager Pat Murray on the special events at Country Club of Ocala.
We have a lot of events, special events here that are geared towards the family. Easter comes to mind. We have an Easter bunny who hops around on the driving range. We usually hide somewhere in a neighborhood of 3,000 eggs and turn them loose and let them go harvest the eggs. We have a great family celebration here on the 4th of July where it's a traditional cookout, if you will. And as the sun goes down, the driving range becomes alive with probably one of the better fireworks displays in the area. Breakfast with Santa is a big deal.
Country Club of Ocala, where the Easter Bunny, Santa, and all the children, large and small, are a big deal on every special occasion. For more information, call 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of the Bundy Gator Report, right here on The Source.
Requires bank approval. Vehicle purchase across the fixed rate allowance.
Yahoo! Kids are back in school and report cards are right around the corner. I've got old cars shaking in their boots because I'm flunking clunkers and junkers this month.
Hey, Professor Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. What's a smart plan to keep you from flunking out in a car that can't make the grade?
This week, trade in and save more. Get the appraised value of your old car plus up to $4,500 off a nicer, newer car.
Stuck in bad credit detention? Our For the People credit approval process wants to help everyone. Even if you've been turned down before.
I vow that no car will be left behind.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales today.
Yes, during our old car report card event, you'll get up to $4,500 off a nicer, newer car, plus the appraised value of your old car. But hurry, my old car report card event ends September 30th, or after we've helped 67 students pass the test in a nicer, newer car. My name is Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala or Bellevue, or call 694-1234. See you at Prestige.
Hey, it's Christy with Ocala Mac and PC Repair and Ocala Guest Wi-Fi to let you know we have you covered. We are the only local certified Apple and Microsoft computer company in Ocala. We are family owned and operated. From mobile repair to wireless networks, viruses, new systems, or security cameras, we do it all. Check us out online, ocalamacpc.com, or give us a call, 352-566-8324.
Tell them Nick, Madison, or Mason sent you and get free diagnostic.
Get your internet telephone service from the company that brought affordable internet service to Ocala in the first place. All is Safe is a sister company of Ocala Guest Wi-Fi, a company you've known and trusted for all your internet needs. Whether you need a phone or hundreds, we've got the products and services to meet your needs both now and in the future. Our plans include everything from local and long-distance calling to equipment maintenance and even software upgrades. You can count on All is Safe to give you cost certainty knowing that your bill will be the same next week, next month, or even next year. Call 352-450-8647 today to learn how to cut your monthly telephone bill up to 60%.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
If you get a migraine, try to hug your family more often or your pets. The chemical oxytocin, which is released when we hug a loved one, it can cut the intensity of a migraine headache in half. Today, a lot of people think that flirting via text message is as bad as cheating in real life. Comedies may get us laughing and help us forget our pain for a few minutes, but sad songs and movies actually help us get over the pain much quicker.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Ag finish up hour two of the program on a Monday. Kind of overcast, rainy. It's not raining so much now, but earlier today. Still, I don't know what the forecast is, but bring your umbrella just in case. It's fall now. Before the break, we talked about what could you do away with on the image to make it shorter. We started having the discussion, and you know, I don't want to see them do away with the things like the opening, which are clever. You know, Les Moonves was that guy, by the way, in case you didn't know who he was. I didn't at first. I had to be told. And if you saw the opening, you saw Neil Patrick Harris walk out the door. He turned security guard, and he was the president of CBS.
Right.
That's who it was. Some of the routines were funny. I think they're entertaining. Like Laurie Martin Gregory said earlier, maybe you can go a little bit shorter on the tributes to everybody. This is different this year. I understand. I disagree. I think Gandolfini was worth it. I think he, after all, I mean, he was made a significant contribution to television. But, you know, how the Academy Awards does is a little bit. They scroll over and play the music and right. They show a scene. And probably. And then you had a couple. You thought, I'll be honest with you, I look at the list. The list of awards are not that long. But maybe you could, like, take a couple of them off TV. Like, I hate to say it for my fellow writer brethren. But, you know, you could have the writers receive their Emmys, you know, off stage or before the show or whatever, and for certain ones.
Do they do the show live?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the problem. If they make these award shows a few hours earlier
and edit it down,
yeah. Nobody would have a problem.
Twitter would make it no need to watch it.
It would lose something if you didn't have it.
But if it's not on TV, nobody can tweet it.
Well, that's the point,
the people there would be tweeting it. The press there that's covering it.
I like real time. I like real time. So you guys got a category or not?
Yeah, I got one. Outstanding host for reality or reality competition program.
Yeah.
I like that one.
The host of the program.
Yeah, that would be like the Hell's Kitchen guy. What's his name?
That's right. No, this was the people up this year. Ryan Seacrest for American Idol. Betty White for Off Her Rockers. Tom Bergeron for Dancing with the Stars. Heidi Klum and Ten Gun for Project Runway. And Kat Deely for So You Think You Can Dance.
Yeah, but we could do with that.
That wasn't on the list that got seen, was it?
That got seen, didn't it?
I don't know. It didn't. I got the list in front of me here, and that's not even – they wouldn't even show.
It's on the list I got.
Well, anyway, I don't think so. I'm not finding it. Maybe I'm overlooking it.
All right.
I think you mentioned this earlier. I agree. You can do without choreography, although I'm a big fan of Derek Hough. My wife loved the fact they had that. And I hate to say it about my fellow writers, but again – they are great, a big part of it and all that stuff. Don't get me wrong. I think you should receive it, but I don't know they have to come out and accept it on the stage.
I don't understand, and I know why they did it, because it was in the 70s and it was a huge thing and all. But outstanding movie or miniseries, you know, I could see giving an award for that, but and maybe even the lead actor in one of those, but then the supporting actors and stuff, give them that off the stage. Miniseries aren't a huge deal. You know, in the 70s you had Roots and Thornbirds, and you had all kind of. I mean, there seemed like there was a miniseries on Shogun came on. You remember all those miniseries, buddy? And yeah. Miniseries aren't that big a deal anymore.
Well, show you what you got. Well, they are, because HBO had a big one in behind the candelabra. Look at this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 categories for miniseries movies. Now, HBO was a big one, and that was more and more big stars are playing HBO, and there are more movies coming to. You know, all coming to television. So
the backstory about Behind the Candelabra, though, was that movie was originally filmed and slated for theaters,
right?
And the executives decided it was too
racing,
too overly homosexual racy.
Yeah,
and so they decided to send it to HBO.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah, I don't know. That's JJ. You have one in particular.
No, that's okay. Yeah. I could do without any of them, really. Yeah. Yeah. Except like the main actor.
In fact,
actor,
just trash the whole show. Get rid of it. What
you know,
the heck,
I'm not a big award show guy.
Yeah, I know. Do you watch the Oscars at all, JJ?
No.
JJ didn't watch any of the award shows.
All right, that's fine. He's got better things to do.
I feel like people in those shows are too stuck up, you know.
Stuck up.
And okay. I liked when Chris Rock tried to be a little edgy. And then you got people like Sean Penn who go up there and act like he's doing such a bad job. You shouldn't talk about people like that. You know, we are all in this business. We all work. Ugh.
What almost spoiled it for me was when they were doing political statements. That got a little bit all over.
Sean Penn does one every time he gets George Clooney. It's terrible.
I mean, I'm okay with them believing in that stuff, and if they want to do it, but don't do it on my entertainment.
Go up there and say thanks for watching my show. Don't go up there and say, by the way.
It makes me regret watching your movie. Jeez.
All right. All right, let's roll out with
do it.
A few short tweets and quotes. We've got a big sports hour coming up, Buddy Sports Page. Check the latest news, standings, scores, all the information, review of the weekend, all coming your way. The freshest sports show in town. Number one, life consists not in holding good cards. Tom, you know this is a poker word, but in playing those cards you hold well.
Exactly.
Or two, when you feel like quitting, think about why you started. Number three, this came from Norm MacDonald, of all people. I thought it was brilliant.
Welcome.
When I look at babies, I can hear God's voice say, you keep wanting proof, and I keep providing it.
Every little bird in the tall old tree. Norm MacDonald?
Yeah, he was on a Twitter fest last night. He did about 15 in a row answering people's questions. That was one of the questions, and that was his response. I thought that was brilliant. And the one Saturday Night Live show I saw live, he hosts.
I love him.
He was not hosting. He was the warm-up act. Okay. Yeah, he was funny as it could be. So, yeah, he's good. Big golf fan. All right, stay tuned to the Sports Space. Coming up next right here on 1370 AM.
96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer because if you're crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumbatomics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are.
This is Austin Tavern reminding you to stay in contact with us at WOCA. Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Voice of Ocala. Make sure to become a friend of our Facebook page and call us at 622-9622.
Dry, itchy, scaly skin? Do you have psoriasis? Consider joining our research study. Renstar Medical Research in Ocala is conducting a research study evaluating the effectiveness of investigational combination of two study medications for moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. You may qualify if you're between the ages of 18 and 75 and have been diagnosed with moderate to severe plaque psoriasis for at least 6 months. For more information, please call Renstar in Ocala at 352-629-5800. Qualified participants may receive study-related medical care and study medication. Compensation for time and travel may also be provided. To find out more information about this psoriasis study, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. That's 352-629-5800. Renstar Medical Research, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Good talk, great conversation. WOCA, News Talk 1370.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is once again that time of year to vote for Ocala Magazine's Best of the Best. Each year, you have the power to go online and vote for your favorite chef, restaurant, hotel, and of course, your favorite radio show. So go online to ocalamagazine.com and vote for Larry and Robin in the morning on WOCA, The Source.
Jacob, you forgot the voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
Ah, yes, of course. Then also vote for the voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
No, Jacob, they can't vote for both.
Well, that does present a problem. How do they decide?
I don't really care, just as long as they vote.
Are you always like this?
Like what?
So charming and friendly.
Oh, then yes. Yes, I am. Now wrap it up already.
Okay then, to recap, go to OcalaMagazine.com and vote for anyone you want, as long as it's Larry and Robin in the Morning or the voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin on WOCA, The Source. How's that?
It'll do.
Don't ever miss a single edition of the Mike Huckabee Show. We're going to have a whole lot of fun talking to big issues of the day. We'll talk to the newsmakers and the issues that made them a newsmaker, as well as we'll bring you some entertainment, some fun. You never know what's going to happen on the Mike Huckabee Show. Don't miss it.
Join Mike Huckabee every weekday from noon to 3, exclusively on WOCA, The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. We're in Florida. Clouds and some sunshine today with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm around, particularly during the afternoon hours, high 84 to 88. It'll be mostly cloudy tonight with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm, low 72 to 76. Tomorrow and Wednesday will be rather cloudy with rain at times along with a thunderstorm or two, high both days between 84 and 88. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
1370 WOCA.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
ABC News Now, I'm Stephen Portnoy. She was at the center of a scandal months after the Internal Revenue Service admitted wrongdoing, scrutinizing applications for tax-exempt status. Lois Lerner, the woman who headed the agency's tax-exempt division, is retiring. A week from tomorrow, the U.S. government will shut down if both sides can't settle their differences. Republicans insist on defunding Obamacare, and that's unacceptable to Democrats. Kenyan security officials are claiming the upper hand at the Westgate Mall 3 days after terrorists began their deadly siege. The winner of last week's $400 million Powerball jackpot has come forward. South Carolina lottery officials say the winner hopes to remain anonymous. They tell us this was only the second time he's ever played. Stocks closed lower today. The Dow was off nearly 50 points, the Nasdaq down 9. After announcing a massive layoff last week, BlackBerry's got a buyer, the PDA maker selling itself to a private equity firm for $4.7 billion. This is ABC News.
They call me Murphy, and I'm a service tech at Quick Lane Tire and Auto Center. It was 9:30 on a Saturday morning, and a Kona Blue Mustang drove in.
I'm due for a tire rotation. Overdue, I'm sure.
Well, better late than never. I poured her a cup of coffee, black.
Hey, can I hop on Wi-Fi?
Sure thing, no charge. She checked her emails and I checked the tires. Pressure was low in one.
Is it bad?
It's below the manufacturer's recommendation. Could affect your fuel economy. I properly inflated the tires, then rotated and aligned them. Did our Quick Lane multi-point inspection, too. Looked good. Took about a half hour, tops. Well, you're all set.
Thanks for fitting me in.
We always do. A Quick Lane tech is always ready to serve.
Get extraordinary service for routine maintenance at Quick Lane Tire and Auto Center. With a full range of services, great prices on 13 name brand tires, and no appointment necessary. Quick Lane is ready to serve. Visit quicklane.com.
How much time? 30? 30 seconds? I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho.
And now it's time for the Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
It's like I don't fit in. It's like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poor house at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now, here's Buddy.
All right, time for the sports page on a Monday. Monday Night Football coming up. A boring weekend of football.
Yes.
not the least of which was because of the lousy schedules, which I hope college football gets severe penalties over in the upcoming course. After this year, they won't have to worry about the rankings. They'll have a panel doing it. And I hope the panel will penalize people for playing small schools. We've had this conversation on this show a lot about, yeah, I get that it's a payday. JJ, we talked about some Saturday, and I think you misunderstood me saying I was trashing the small colleges or the FCS.
No, I didn't misunderstand you. I was just letting you know there is some out there that not only are they going to get paid, but they're coming to win.
I understand that. Now, you remember that it's possible that, you know, Appalachian State could beat Michigan. By the way, Michigan had to struggle a little bit this weekend. That can happen. I'm not saying you should never play them, but there's so many obvious mismatches. Florida's got a schedule this year. They've got two, including Tom's old school. Right. And you got to talk about your value of your product. Now, when you look at your schedule of your team, and you see how many home games you've got, and you see how many of them are FCS schools, you'd be entitled to a refund, I think. Because if you look at it strictly from the standpoint of entertainment value, and like it or not, that's what it is in college sports today. That's why they're getting so much money. There's a real conundrum here about this whole thing. I'm going to talk about it in a minute, about getting all that money from TV and having small crowds and having home games with small schools, and it's all beginning to worry me. Meanwhile, there's news to be talked about. J.J. LaSalva's in our newsroom.
Yes.
And he's got the headlines.
Let's do it. Well, we all saw the Gators win. It was ugly, but they won 31-17 on Saturday. Jeff Driskel breaks his leg, out for the season. So we'll see what happens with the backup quarterback. Looked pretty good coming in. This weekend, the Braves, the A's, Red Sox, Dodgers all clinched a division. St. Louis clinched a playoff spot. They're still battling, and they might have to play in the wild card, but it looks like they'll probably clinch the Central. And the Rays, off of a couple very important wins this weekend, up two games in the wild card. Looks like they'll probably get in. Alden Smith, we talked about him a little bit last week. He'll miss Thursday night's game at St. Louis and perhaps sit out longer, the CEO of the Niners said, because he will be going through treatment to fix his problem. But he had a DUI and he was arrested with marijuana.
He's got serious addiction problems.
All right. And RG3 lost yet again yesterday. 0-3 this season, the Washington Redskins are. And in case you didn't know it yourself just by looking at the TV, Pierre Garçon came out today to let us know that RG3 is still not fully healthy. Mm. But we'll see what happens with that. And like you said, the FCS versus FBS teams, buddy. I want to give you this.
Give me step. That. Let's break that. You ready to break that down now? Yeah. You want to wait?
We could do that right now. That's pretty much all the headlines right now.
Okay. Well, is there another story about Jeannie?
Jeannie Buss.
Buss talking about how she was betrayed over the D'Antoni hiring.
By her brother.
By her own brother. And
this is coming out because she's got a book coming out pretty soon.
Yeah.
She's updated her Laker Girl memoir, says that she felt betrayed by the hiring of Mike D'Antoni as head coach last year instead of Phil Jackson, and was betrayal. We all know Phil Jackson is her hubby, so obviously that's going to push some buttons. You got to keep work at work, buddy. You know, that's a tough situation to deal with. I don't know how you go about hiring your boyfriend or husband when your brother wants to hire Mike D'Antoni.
Or fiancé, whatever it is.
It's just a messy situation.
Well, the one that got me interested, and we'll talk about these, is two stories in this whole lineup. Tom, you might want to weigh in on this one. One of them is that Shaq buys part of the Kings. He's going to be an owner. He's all former NBA players and got so much money. And they got as much money as the owners have got. And the last thing I want to mention is this whole college football thing is about to explode, and the president of the NCAA, Emmert, made a comment today about a lot of changes coming. It's about time. And I'll talk about some of the changes that he discusses and also the changes that we'd like to see and some of the issues that they've got to face. You got to look into the product eventually, JJ and Tom, because if you're charging elite prices, you better have elite opponents. And it's just not happening right now in college football.
I think that's all going to change probably because, like you said, now it comes down to a group of people like us, not computers, who look at who people have played and make judgments on that, on who should be in the national title, who should be in the top four playoffs. So you're going to see less and less of Georgia Southern's and who else did Florida have this year?
I got to look at it.
Toledo's a 1A school.
No, it's not Toledo. It's another one.
The only 1AA school Florida plays this year is Georgia Southern.
Yeah.
Everybody else is a...
Well, you know a lot about that one because you went there.
Right. And Georgia Southern's fixing to be... The problem with it is you're not going to alleviate the problem by stopping playing FCS schools. Because what's going to happen is FBS schools are going to go find... All of a sudden, conferences like the Sun Belt are going to become very popular on the Saturdays they want people there. And, oh, by the way, Georgia Southern, Appalachian State joining the Sun Belt. A lot of these FCS schools are making enough money or have over a time period made enough money by playing these games that they're not able to move up. So the problem's not going to be eliminated. It's just going to look a little better because everybody's an FBS school. But let's be honest. And I said this at the alumni meetings we had at Georgia Southern and everything. Georgia Southern's moving up to FBS to play in the Sun Belt. They're going to go from being able to compete for a national championship every year to now being able to play at the Champ Sport Bowl on December 28th if they have a good year. That's really a move up, huh?
Well, it's a bigger payday.
Of course it's a bigger payday. But it's not a move up competition-wise. And the Sun Belts of the world and the AAU, FS, whatever that conference is Louisville's in, I mean, the conference schedule Louisville's playing is a joke.
Right.
Well, here's the deal.
And that's what's going to happen.
Good point. Here's the deal, and then we're going to talk about this where we break it down, is in the end, when they all got their musical chairs, how many schools play, how many of them play for FCS, in that FBS division, they're going to be divisions. And let's say if we have – what do we have now? 115 FBSs?
Right, 115.
I got it broken it down someplace. Do you think for 1 minute all those are going to be included in the big payday?
Northern Illinois, no. Central Michigan, no. Those teams have no shot. They have no reason to even be playing in
less than
FBS.
Half of those teams are going to wind up in the elite conference playing for all the money. It's just not going to happen. Football's not like basketball. You can't have
none.
And so you're going to wind up. You may be in the FBS, but that didn't punch your ticket. So that's a whole issue to itself. Anyway, lots to talk about. I want to weigh in on Tyler Murphy. I think the kid did a terrific job. I'll tell you, somebody else thinks he did a terrific job. One of his opposing coaches watched on TV and had some things to say about Tyler Murphy, a guy who's waited his turn all this time. Sat around now for almost 4 years.
Red shirt junior.
And never had, in fact, I believe gave his jersey number. We have to look this
when
up.
When was the last time you heard he's a red shirt junior?
Unless he was had played, never, you know.
Right.
So,
you never hear anybody referred to as a
red shirt
junior.
We're going to break that down. We're going to talk about the schedules. We're going to talk about that. Plus, lots more coming your way right here on Buddy Sports Space. So stay tuned to
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me and JJ LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. I want to tell you about a conversation I had recently with General Manager Pat Murray on the great family atmosphere at Country Club of Ocala.
It's a family first club. Again, we have any number of different types of memberships, but obviously the one that attracts the greatest level of interest is our family. And the reason for that is we have a little bit of something for everybody. I mean, we obviously have a world-class golf course. We have seven tennis courts here for all levels of tennis players. We have a junior Olympic size swimming pool. We have a fitness center that's second to none. And we have state-of-the-art equipment in our fitness center.
Country Club of Ocala, where the facilities are all a family would ever need. For more information, call today at 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of Bundy's Gator Report and Gator Talk Thursday right here on The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
WOCA.
Life may not come with guarantees, but buying your next vehicle from Ford Lincoln of Ocala sure does. Start with their 7-day new vehicle price guarantee. If you find the identical new Ford or Lincoln vehicle anywhere else for less, Ford Lincoln of Ocala will refund you 110% of the difference. That's guaranteed. In the market for a quality pre-owned vehicle? Buy with confidence with Ford Lincoln of Ocala's 30-day pre-owned exchange policy. That's guaranteed. Ford Lincoln of Ocala's goal is to make buying your next vehicle fun, simple, fast, and guaranteed. Shop Ford Lincoln of Ocala today on North Highway 441, open 7 days a week, or shop at home at fordofocala.com. A 7-day new vehicle price guarantee, a 30-day pre-owned vehicle exchange policy. That's buying with confidence. That's buying from Ford Lincoln of Ocala. That's guaranteed. Ford Lincoln of Ocala reserves the right to verify quotes, advertised prices, 30-day pre-owned exchange policy, or 1,000 miles from date of purchase. Does not apply to vehicles sold as is. See dealer for complete details.
Cookies, 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 cookies.
We go when you cookies. Want something special and fun for any occasion, get cookies. That's right. The Great American Cookie Company in the Paddock Mall, Ocala, will make a delicious, fun-filled delight just for you. You might notice that I said fun and delicious more than once. That's because I can't say it enough. The next time you're at the mall, be sure and stop by or call 352-237-2557 to place your order.
Cookies, cookies,
yum.
Cookies, cookies. We go cookie eating cookies.
The Great American Cookie Company.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a 3-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
It's all about the caliber of the competition. That's what we're having a discussion about here today. In the break, a heated discussion about the caliber of your competition. It's quality. You're very fortunate when you get to see a Tim Tebow at the college level. You get to see, you know, Tiger Woods at the top of his game. And you get to see unique players. You see teams that are great, or you see players that are great. And it makes you appreciate them more when you have to say, and no offense to the Swedes out there, but Henrik Stenson winning the FedEx Cup, please.
Boring.
He's in the top five in the world.
Great. That's great.
He's one of, he, according to golf rankings, is one of the top five best golfers in the world.
Would he be in your top five?
Yes, he would be in my top five.
All right.
Yes.
Hey, well,
but the point you're making is, would he be in the average golf fan's top five? Well, no, of course not. People are saying, Henrik, what, huh?
Let me just say this. The man in the mall one day, I'm going to send him out with the pictures of people saying, who are these people?
Oh, people couldn't pick Henrik.
Tiger, Stenson.
The only reason I know Henrik Stenson is because I cover golf. You're right. The average person, if you put six photos and all of them were Henrik Stenson and ask them to pick him out, they'd tell you, I don't know which one he is.
Look, I've been in many, many, many golf press rooms, okay?
Yeah.
And I guarantee you that at the press room over the weekend, that people who follow golf and follow it closely, like Bob Herrick of the St. Pete Times,
right.
Doug First AP, my friend Dan Jenkins,
right?
They're groaning thinking they have to write stories about Henrik Stenson.
Oh, I guarantee you they are.
You know, saying, my gosh, not that there's anything wrong with him as a person, and he won it fair and square. But the reason golf is where it is Tiger Woods. And then go backwards from there, throwing in Lee, Trevino, people forget about them, Tom Watson, then back to Nicklaus and back to Palmer. It's marquee. It's the individual people who make up the storyline that drive the popularity of the sport.
And Henrik Stenson didn't win a golf tournament this year. Finished in the top 10.
He didn't win one?
No,
he didn't win. The first tournament he won was the Deutsche Bank Classic once they were in the FedEx Cup, the four tournaments for the FedEx Cup.
Yeah, but the regular season he didn't. That's regular what I'm saying. Can you really have a golfer of the year who didn't win an event?
Well, he's not the golfer of the year. He's FedEx Cup champ.
Yeah, well, whatever.
Golfer of the year is Tiger Woods. But yeah, I would make a discussion that Jordan Spieth should have been golfer of the year.
Well,
a kid without a card.
You have to qualify, so you can't win it unless you have at least one victory in the year?
And Jordan Spieth had two.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean for the FedEx Cup?
Yeah, FedEx Cup.
Well, he did win. He won the Deutsche Bank
Championship.
Yeah, but
after he qualified. After they qualified.
Well, they take the top 125 money list qualifies. If you said it's the top 125, but everybody's got to win, well, then you wouldn't start but with 35 golfers.
Anyway, I'll just leave it like this. We're talking about caloric competition. We're going to go back from golf now to football. And we had a conversation before the break. We're going to get into Tyler Murphy in just a minute, too, because it's an important story, I think. I don't want to see the expectations get too out of this kid. This is a terrific kid, by the way, Tyler Murphy. He waited his chance. He got his turn. He did the job. And I think kudos to him because, quite frankly, I think they were going to have to bench Driscoll at some point. And I don't know if they had the guts to do it. But now they had no choice to do that. And Murphy stepped up and did a terrific job over the weekend against not a very good Tennessee team. But, hey, they lost the game. Who knows? Let's talk for a second about caliber competition. The big-time schools are called FBS. This is so ridiculous, by the way. And the small schools, quote-unquote, are FCS. And, you know, I can give you the numbers if you need for me, too, about how many there are in each category. But the deal is that there's at least one cupcake on every schedule, and sometimes two, but particularly one, where you have the big schools play the small schools, and the small schools get a payday, which Georgia Southern will do when they come to town next to the last game of the year and play in Florida Field and get what, Tom, $900,000 or something like that, whatever.
Yeah, they're going to get a little less than $1 million.
And it's, you know, I understand that.
And that's a huge payday for a school like Georgia Southern.
That's all. This is charity. That's good, okay? But when you play that many schools like this weekend, we had not one single team, ranked team, lose a game. And not even really contested except for maybe from Michigan. You know,
stink.
And you know, what is the deal? And then you look at it and you say, what's wrong? Well, look at this. JJ, do you have the scores and do you have the teams now?
Yeah, we could do both.
Yeah, because this is some
overall,
of the teams.
This is just the top 25.
Just top 25 teams.
And this is just FCS.
Versus
because
FBS.
There was plenty of, I could have done a lot more, because there was plenty of people like Bama who played Colorado State.
Right.
Or Louisville who played FIU. That doesn't even count in my book, because those are
the FBS
teams.
Schools. Right.
But just out of the top 25, there was five games.
Okay.
Including Ohio State, Florida A&M, Bethune, Florida State, Miami played Savannah State. Let's see, Washington played Idaho State, and Northwestern played Maine. Okay, out of all those,
right,
the combined score for the FBS teams,
mm-hmm, the big
298.
Teams. 298 for the big guys.
Just ballpark.
Can I guess?
Yeah.
50.
34. And 21 of those came in one game. Maine only lost 21-35 to
Northwestern. Black Bears can play, baby.
So take away that.
The main Black Bears.
It's 13 points to 290.
If you take away the main game, the other four games are
77-7, 54-6, 76-0, and 56-0. And that's not including Florida International losing 72-0.
With a running clock.
Right.
But, buddy, and here's the bad thing. Not only were these games just stinkers, but then the games that you think could save the weekend, Michigan State, Notre Dame, Florida, Tennessee.
LSU, Auburn.
Were horrible games, too.
Actually, LSU-Auburn wasn't horrible.
And Michigan State was actually a good game.
Yeah, Michigan State-Notre Dame game was terrible.
Had it not rained like it did in Baton Rouge, I think I was impressed the way Auburn played. That quarterback,
put up like 300-plus yards.
Did you see some of the throws this kid made?
Well, those are both quarterbacks that couldn't get
this
to
Auburn
Georgia
team is not bad. Now, granted, They got some studs in the backfield for LSU.
To put up 300-plus total yards in the rain against LSU at home, that's hard.
Right.
And they were down 21-0 at halftime, but that just shows a young team
but
that's able to
well
come
in
back.
Second half.
All right, that's legit.
So, but anyway, hey, just on note on this Ohio State game, you know this character adventure, the score between A&M and Ohio State at halftime?
I think it was in the 50s.
55-0 at halftime.
Right. Ridiculous.
Talking about calling off the dogs
in
the second half.
Isn't the point
half
of sports, by the way, can we not forget that we watch this to enjoy and be entertained?
Competition.
Sports is supposed to be competitive. Yeah. It's supposed to be maybe one team could win on any given Saturday. There's no way these teams can win. They don't have a chance.
And see, it's not fun to watch. And the proponents of this will tell you, all you got to do is look at basketball, the mid-majors. This isn't basketball. A guy at 320 running a 4.8 40 at Alabama is better than the guy 290 that runs a 5.2 40 at Savannah State. I'm sorry, that's just how it is.
Yeah, Miami 77-7. That's really a joke.
And could have been 100.
And they ran the clock, kept it going, and there was supposedly a mistake.
No, that was
in the Louisville game where Louisville won big. But somehow or another, the official misunderstood, quote unquote,
the Miami game. They
the
didn't
attention
run
of what was going on there, and thought that the coach from Florida International said, "Keep it running." The score of that game was 38-0. Final 72-0 with a second half clock issue. Coordinator of officials for the Conference USA says there was a clock issue during the second half of the number 7 Louisville 72 victory over Florida International. Said Gerald Austin says the clock was allowed to run at times when it should have been stopped. I think it's called a mercy killing, I'm not sure.
Well, in the Miami game, how embarrassing is this? Miami's playing Savannah State. The last quarter, the fourth quarter, they get together and say, hey, let's go back to the high school time limit on a quarter.
Well, because their Savannah State coach was too proud to say, yeah, let's have a running clock.
Right, so they went from a 15-minute quarter to the high school time limit, which is 12 minutes.
You know,
that's more embarrassing to me to go back to a high school time
limit. Some of these teams, I understand when they put cupcakes on the schedule, and when I say some of these teams, I mean SEC teams. But Miami, you don't need to have Savannah State on the set. Florida State, you don't need to have Nevada, Bethune-Cookman, and a mid-November game against Idaho on your schedule when you already play nobody.
Don't be talking to Vandals. The Vandals may come up and beat Florida State.
Yeah, so anyway, so all this spells.
Called the Vandals?
And I'm going to get to the story about the Tyler Murphy, too. All this is in context of what we're going to talk about at the break, which is the issues that the players they're having with the players. There's some evidence now of dissidence. Players have come out now, and they've protested the fact that they don't think that their health and their welfare and the money issue and what have you, compensation and health care, I think, are the two things they said. This new group wore stuff on their towels and different parts of their uniforms through three schools, and now we're beginning to see seeds of rebellion among the players. And now the NCAA president, Mark Emmert, says a lot of change will be coming soon. So you can feel it. It's in the wind. But I want to get to Tyler Murphy. Now, I tried to find this out from somebody today, and I asked a question of a guy at Florida. He wasn't sure. And I could be wrong, but I think I'm right. Tyler Murphy waited his turn, as we said. He went in when Jeff Driscoll broke his leg, the bone in his leg. Yeah. When he went in, I tweeted, this kid's not bad. And, I've seen him play in the spring game and stuff, and I thought he did okay. I didn't expect him to have a great game, but I got thinking, I think he was the player. JJ, if you could find this, I couldn't find it on Google. And I asked somebody at Florida today, and they weren't sure. I think he was a player. I believe he was number 10 last year. He didn't play. And a freshman came on board this year, and I can't remember the details of the story, something along the lines of the freshman's mother had died on a certain date, or number 10 was significant to the freshman, and he really wanted that jersey. And Tyler Murphy, who's paid his dues here, said, okay, you can have it. Just gave him his jersey, which I thought, how many people would do that for an incoming freshman? So we can look that up and maybe find out. But the whole deal is that I really loved his decision-making, when to pull it down and run, when to pitch it, when to cut, when to throw. He made very few mistakes. I thought he played well. And then I read this. Listen to this quote. I'll tell you what, yesterday the most impressive player I thought in college football was a quarterback that came into the game down at Florida, a kid named Tyler Murphy, said Steve Spurrier.
Well, there you go.
Spurrier said in his weekly teleconference, he said, it's unfortunate that Jeff Driscoll broke his fibula and his ankle, but he said, I didn't even know who the second team quarterback was. I don't think anybody knew too much. And then we find out this kid's been there 5 years paying his dues, not really five, but four, doing whatever they ask him to do. So really sort of a heartwarming feeling when a young man who has been there 5 years gets a chance to go in there and plays well. So Murphy, of course, never had thrown a pass in college football. Finished 8 for 14 for 134 yards, 52-yard touchdown on a screen pass, Solomon Patton, and he rushed for 84 yards on 10 carries. So pretty darn good
obviously, performance. Very, very impressed by the rushing above everything.
You know who's the most angry about this whole thing?
Jacoby Brissett.
Jacoby Brissett.
Well, like they used to say, you pay your money, you take your chances. You know,
exactly.
That's how it is. Turn Austin off.
No, we don't want to eat.
All right, you're good.
Go ahead.
I'm reading a tweet from Mark Long, who is a friend of the show that is quoting Will Muschamp. It says, he didn't handle things the right way. He handled things perfectly.
Yeah. Yeah, Muschamp got lucky there because he hadn't shown a lot of love to Tyler Murphy. And like Spurrier said, most people didn't even know who the backup quarterback was.
I think Muschamp, when he went down, said, who we got coming in now?
Who's that, Murphy? Who's that now? Is he
Murphy, that's the kid that brings me the charts at the end of the game, right?
Yeah.
Is that the guy wrapping the wire up on my headset? Who is that guy?
You know, it's funny. What this team needed right now was a feel-good story of some kind. Something to get him over the hump. And I think they may have found it. Now, does this mean that Murphy's going to be the next Tim Tebow? Or no. The kid's limited. But I think he's a good game manager. He's matured in his decisions. I think Brent Peace will find. That was the problem. Here's the irony. I was talking to somebody closely connected with the Florida program. I mean, employee.
On the inside.
Employee University of Florida on the inside, okay, that is very well known. And I had lunch at the table, and we were talking. He says, what do you think of this team? He said to me, and I said, you know, I'm having a problem understanding why there's a disconnect between Brent Peace and Jeff Driscoll. And he said to me, buddy, Driscoll is a horrible decision maker. He said he just makes bad – this is before the game now.
Right.
And he says, you know, he turned it over three times in the red zone against Miami. He just – and he goes out the first quarter. What does he do? He makes some bad decisions.
Yeah.
He holds the ball too long, or he throws it when he should run it. Or I mean, he just doesn't seem to be able – he's not matured.
And with this defense, you don't need somebody making bad decisions. You need somebody that can control. Because this defense is one of the best defenses I've seen in a long time in college football.
Cannot have a guy that turns it over.
It's hard for me to look at any of these big-time schools and say they have a better defense than Florida does right now.
I think they got as good a defense as there is. And you know what? And the fans are starting to get into it a little bit, too. The defense is really getting people jacked up. Now, remember, they lost three defensive backs during that game. One sat out. One got ejected. And one got hurt.
Well, that whole ejection rule.
They were scrambling for you know at the end because you know because they had the DBs weren't there. So
luckily for them, they have Kentucky next.
A judgment call by referees and it can end up in an ejection.
It's tough.
What the intent was, but it's ridiculous.
They're about 50-50 on those so far. They missed a few. Anyway, congratulations, Tyler Murphy. I gotta say, I'm rooting for the kid. I don't dislike Jeff Driscoll. I think this kid has waited. It's his turn.
It's a good story.
What they need now, as JJ says, with a defense like that, you just need a good decision maker and a game manager, and you got hope. Now, will they win all the rest of their games? No.
Matt Jones needs to quit fumbling, too.
Yeah.
He's a guy who's a turnover machine, it looks like.
Yeah,
just
he's got to stop
Driscoll.
That, too. So this team, they've got some tough games coming up here. If you watched LSU at all, get ready for it.
Mettenberger can really throw the ball.
They got some running backs that'll knock your socks off, too. So you better watch that team. And Georgia's no piece of cake. So they got some games. South Carolina's going to give you all you want to. So conceivably, this team could lose three, maybe even four games if they're not careful. You had Florida State in there. So
is Driscoll a senior?
Driscoll's a junior.
Okay.
And we don't know about his red shirt, medical red shirt, or whatever. So, anyway.
First round draft pick.
This was the best thing for his career.
Yeah. They could go play baseball. So.
Yeah.
All right. We come back. We'll talk a little bit more about what? College football.
We can talk NFL, baseball.
NFL this week was putrid as well.
Well, the Dolphins. We got the best team.
The Dolphins look good.
Franz Beard coming up. We'll talk with him. But Or we'll look at the schedule also in the college football schedule. Good games come up this week, yes, too. So we'll return after this timeout on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. Streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Having the motivation and making the commitment to quit smoking is a great first step towards becoming smoke-free. However, anyone who's tried to quit smoking knows how challenging it can be. Having the determination to quit may not be enough. You may need some help. If you're ready to quit smoking and are between the ages of 18 and 75, currently smoke 10 or more cigarettes a day, and can commit to participating for 24 weeks, you may be interested in a research study which is being conducted to evaluate the use of investigational drugs to see if they can aid individuals in their quest to quit smoking. To help you quit, smoking cessation counseling and all study-related medical care will be provided at no extra cost. You may also be reimbursed for your travel time. To receive more information about this study, how you can participate, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's Renstar Medical Research in Ocala, 352-629-5800.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with their clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
WOCA. Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and low rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is once again that time of year to vote for Ocala Magazine's Best of the Best. Each year, you have the power to go online and vote for your favorite chef, restaurant, hotel, and of course, your favorite radio show. So go online to OcalaMagazine.com and vote for Larry and Robin in the morning on WOCA, The Source.
Jacob, you forgot The Voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
Ah, yes, of course. Then also vote for The Voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
No, Jacob, they can't vote for both.
Well, that does present a problem. How do they decide?
I don't really care, just as long as they vote.
Are you always like this?
Like what?
So charming and friendly.
Oh, then yes. Yes, I am. Now wrap it up already.
Okay then, to recap, go to OcalaMagazine.com and vote for anyone you want, as long as it's Larry and Robin in the morning or The Voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin on WOCA, The Source. How's that?
It'll do.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Back at Buddy Sports Page. NFL over the weekend. I've got the ticket. I watched a lot of games. I ended up watching a lot of that Jets-Buffalo game just because it's so crazy. Jets setting a team record for most penalties. It was incredibly sloppy. But I enjoyed their quarterback play, especially, you know, Geno Smith, I got to give it to him. He threw a couple of really good-looking strikes in there.
The game winner down the sideline.
Really a great toss.
Insanely good pass.
And then, of course,
EJ.
EJ Manuel did a pretty good job. He made a few mistakes, but I thought they look out for him. Well, watch out in the future, those two quarterbacks. You know what, guys? The storylines, are you shocked that San Francisco's been taken apart again? That the Packers would lose to the Bengals? That really shocked me. And that the Giants got clobbered by Carolina?
To nothing.
And then Pittsburgh is such is in the garbage.
Pittsburgh's terrible. Pittsburgh is
that's
bad.
That's just not like Pittsburgh. Look at those things. Pittsburgh's never this bad. Like somebody said, when did what happened to this team all of a sudden?
Is that more surprising than Miami's 3-0?
Well, what happened to Pittsburgh is they lost all their talented wideouts, running backs, everybody. Yeah. When you have Dwyer and Felix Jones is like your backfield stars. And Big Ben is getting sacked almost every time.
Big Ben's getting beat up like it's a UFC fight.
Exactly. Before last night, there was 7 sacks in the last 2 games. I don't know how much there was last night, but there was a few more. And even when they sort of inched their way back in the game in the third quarter, you still felt like there's no way they're going to get this.
And their center is a guy who got cut by Tennessee.
Yeah. Ever since Pouncey got getting hurt, right, was big deal.
But here's, to me, the biggest story in the NFL, and everybody says, oh, the Giants 0-3. Tom Coughlin says, nobody's to blame. It's just football. To me, it looks like defensive coordinators, and I always say this because, you know, I'm a defensive guy. Defensive coordinators make a lot of money because they're smart guys, too. Colin Kaepernick looks human now.
Yeah, he does.
Because defensive coordinators are smart guys.
I guess Seattle just keeps getting better and better. You know, I mean, they're right now. Denver and Seattle are going to put them at the top.
Russell Wilson, I think he's listed at 5'11", but I think he's actually 5'6".
I'm really surprised at the success he's had.
I'm amazed at how good he is.
Everybody, that's why he was only like the fourth or fifth quarterback drafted.
Remember, he played at North Carolina State and Wisconsin.
Right, transferred.
Played baseball.
What did I tell you about Wisconsin's program? Yeah. They like to run it.
Yeah.
NC State really can crank out those NFL quarterbacks, though.
And The other team that I don't know their identity is because 1 week they look really good and next week they look really bad is San Diego. I mean, I guess San Diego's going to finish 8-8, and everybody's going to talk about how great Phillip Rivers is, but San Diego's still 8-8. When does Phillip Rivers start getting talked about like Tony Romo gets talked about?
Well, speaking of Tony Romo, the Cowboys this year look really, really good. They look like the best team in the East, especially because the Eagles stink. Washington's really, really
RG3,
bad.
RG3, glad you wasted that pick.
Yeah, that the Giants look even worse than all of them. NFC East is easily garbage. The worst division of football. And the AFC West is the best. And tonight it looks like the Broncos are probably going to pound the Raiders. But
you never know. That's one of those games that has like a college atmosphere. They literally do not like each other.
Right. It will be in Denver.
Which one of these does not belong? You ready? If I was reading this list in July,
okay,
and I said to you, these 5 teams, which one would not belong in July? New York Giants, Washington Redskins, San Francisco 49ers, Pittsburgh Steelers,
Jacksonville.
Yeah, you would think in July you'd say, well, Jacksonville's not going to be that good.
Yeah. Exactly. And yet, look at the teams. They're in the garbage.
Oh, man. I love it. I love seeing these teams like the Steelers, biggest fan base in America, 0-3, bad. And teams like the Dolphins, who, you know, one of the worst fan bases in America, really haven't won in a really, really long time.
It's
they're 3-0.
It's early, JJ.
I don't care. Yeah, the Dolphins look good, buddy.
Yeah, but they're playing, and I hate to say this because I'm a huge Falcons fan, but their win against Atlanta yesterday, while it's a win, Atlanta's horrible on defense. And that's been proven by Seattle coming back from 22 down, San Francisco coming back from 17 down.
Listen,
their defense is bad.
Miami went on the road and beat Indianapolis.
Yeah, I know. Which, by the way, turned out to be pretty good, as we found out.
Yeah, they beat the Browns. It's the Browns. But, I mean, going on the road is tough to do.
Two of the 3 wins they've done have been against bad defensive teams, because the Browns are just bad, period. And the Falcons have to throw up a basketball score on offense to win any football.
Well, look at the Colts out there, who they just buried last weekend. Buried them.
Yeah. Speaking of the Browns, Tom, how about losing your quarterback, having a third-string quarterback, losing your running back, and even though it is against...
Hoyer wins the game.
Even against yeah. It is Minnesota, they go on the road and get a win, the first win of the season.
Hoyer comes in and wins the game for them.
Yeah, it's just... it's
And
it's
Tampa
early,
Bay...
Well, I don't know. Wait, I don't know. I'm sorry. This just in. That was a 16. Yeah. I forgot.
I don't know which team's worse.
Shiano's going to be
Here's
fired.
The thing. Has anybody seen Jacksonville and Tampa playing at the same time? Has anybody seen that? Or could that be the same team just driving
Except
down the interstate?
Birth. Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah.
We just got really bad local teams.
Could the Tampa Bay Jacksonville, could that just be the same team taking a charter bus down 301 from Jacksonville
could
to
be.
Tampa?
Could be. A good point. Yeah.
When the Patriots rookie receiving corps, who has been all over TV for the first 2 weeks about being really crappy
right.
and having videos of your quarterback screaming at you for 2 weeks, when they're putting up absurd numbers, catching multiple touchdowns, Tompkins, who we made fun of for 2 weeks on this show, looked like Randy Moss.
Wait, here's the problem.
Against Darrell Revis.
No, it wasn't against Darrell Revis, and that's the problem. They play zone, and when you got the best cover corner in football, you don't put him – there's a reason it's Revis Island. It's not Revis kind of in the area.
It's not Revis zip code. It's Revis Island.
I mean, they got Revis playing zone. He's the best cover corner in the game. If you want to play zone on the left side of the field, the side Revis is not on.
Plus the fact they gave away those first two games. Gave them away.
Yeah, the first two games they had 23 penalties. Too.
Gave
they only have four yesterday. So that's a lot better.
There's no way the best cover corner in the game should be playing zone.
The most – ironic thing about that game yesterday, LeGarrette Blount, traded from the Bucks in the offseason, led the Patriots with 65 yards rushing.
And rushing, exactly.
All right, guys, we got to go to break, but looking at the schedule right now, it's a few decent games. Oklahoma and Notre Dame is not too bad, although Notre Dame stuck it up just like Michigan State did. LSU-Georgia is the game of the week, for sure.
Fact.
Not Florida-Kentucky?
Yeah, and not Florida State at Boston College, although it's a better opponent.
But that's two BCs in a row, Bethune-Cookman, Boston College. Yep.
There you go. Another game I'm going to watch closely is Wisconsin-Ohio State. So I think those are some good games. Return to some decent competition this weekend for a change. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll check with Franz Beard to follow up on what's happening up in Gainesville with the Gators after this timeout on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of Kinetic Motion Fitness here in Ocala, Florida. A lot of you have experienced our great classes and personal small group training, but did you know we now offer dynamic workouts on DVD? These high-quality, locally produced, effective DVD workouts can go where you go. Going on vacation? No problem. We can go with you. Friends and relatives out of town who are jealous that you get to come to KMF? No problem. We ship anywhere in the United States for free. Our great lineup of four DVDs includes Kinetic Achieve, Kinetic Couples, Kinetic Core, and Kinetic Campus. Four great workouts for the entire family on DVD. Sound interesting? Check them out on our website at kmfocala.com. While you're there, check out our class schedule and come see us. We're only 5 minutes from downtown across from the Skylark Plaza. Visit kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. KMF will get you results at our studio or at home with one of our DVDs. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are. Visit kmfocala.com for more information.
Dr. Seaborn Hunt, a board-certified ophthalmologist in Ocala, offers advanced cataract surgery with laser astigmatism correction to reduce and potentially eliminate your dependence on glasses for both distance and near vision and some areas in between. If you have cataracts or need a second opinion to discuss your lens implant options and determine if you're a candidate for precision multifocal lens implant, call Dr. Hunt's office to set up an appointment to see if you qualify for the upgraded lens. Call Dr. Seaborn Hunt's office today for an appointment, 873-7200. That's 873-7200.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, "It's our business to make your business better." Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine, featuring local businesses and issues and written by local volunteers. Lady Lake Magazine has become a must-read in Marion, Lake, and Sumter counties, audited by Circulation Verification Council and serving the area for 23 years. Plus, Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. All we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 352-804-1223 and pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine today.
Now, read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Gene Powell Pass Chemowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pass Chemowing, 352-629-2440, or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pass Chemowing.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
I face up Monday with a Gator Report from Fran Spirit in Gainesville, and we've had quite a conversation there about these cupcake schedules. What was the combined score against JJ FBS versus top 25 FBS?
290 something against
297 to 34. That's on the top 25.
I thought they scored at least 3,000.
Yeah.
That was just the teams in the top 25, friends.
Yeah, that, of course, and along with Tyler Murphy. I don't know if you remember the story or not. I'm having a hard time tracking it down. I asked a friend of ours today that you know well, and he wasn't sure either. Was Tyler Murphy the guy who gave his jersey away to an incoming freshman?
He might have been.
You ought to research that if you're writing anything, because I seem to remember that. Was he number 10 last year?
Yes, he was.
I'm almost sure it was him then. I think he gave away 10 to an incoming freshman. I'll tell you who that is in just a minute. And because the freshman said it was his mother apparently died or something, and it was his favorite, her favorite day or number or something. And here's a kid who's been sitting there for all these years, Valdez Showers. And
Valdez Showers, was number 10.
You might want to just look that up and see, because that just tells you the kind of kid he is, you know? And I said earlier, Franz, and you can weigh in on this, that this is that feel-good story maybe that this team needed. Murphy to come in,
well,
totally cold, and perform like that.
Well, it says a lot that the kid, you know, stayed here because he said, this is where I came to school. This is where I wanted to be. And, you know, we see stories like that. You know, we used to see them a lot more often back in the day when guys actually hung around. Nowadays, the culture is, okay, you don't get your playing time your freshman year, you're out of there. And this is a kid that hung around and hung around. You got to wonder, you know, for example, like a kid like Cam Newton, what might have happened if he'd hung around? You think about things like that. Jared Faison, another one, who left early because he didn't like Percy Harvin. Had he stayed here and played in Urban's offense in 2009 when Percy was gone, Jared Faison probably would have played himself into a first-round draft pick.
Well, not to mention Gerald Christian, Robert Clark, and a few guys up in Louisville having a good time right now who are all transferred to Louisville. So there's been done that, obviously. So anyway, your assessment, I thought I wouldn't say that Tyler Murphy was brilliant, but I thought he was really impressive.
Very, very impressive. The biggest thing that impressed me, buddy, was he came in there, played with tremendous poise. He didn't get flustered when the rush came. He used his instincts. But the thing I liked about him was even when he's running around back there, he's looking down the field for a receiver, and, you know, he only ran as a last resort. That said a lot about him, is that you know, he, you know, most guys who are new off the bench, you expect that they're either going to unload it too quick or hold on to it too long. This is a guy that was making the plays with his feet, and he's looking upfield the whole time to find a receiver. When that doesn't happen, then he tucks it and runs, finds a good place, and has the presence to slide. Oh, I love that.
Yeah, and I don't know if you saw the story or not, but apparently Steve Spurrier watched on TV from Crescent Beach this weekend and issued a statement that the most impressive player in the country this weekend was Tyler Murphy.
I saw that, and what a compliment from a guy that, as you remember, came off the bench, you know, his first games. It wasn't until the Alabama game, his sophomore year, that he became a starter. And this is a guy, though, that you know, bided his time, you know, what let Tommy Shannon play quarterback. And when the time was right, he got his job, his shot. This is a, you know, I love this about Murphy. He's waited his turn. He's never complained. And it's obvious that, you know, he was going to those meetings and learning something, because when he went in there, I thought he looked like he was tremendously well prepared.
Yeah, make good decisions. All right, Francis, we researched it, and our crack research staff, Austin, found out, in fact, that Valdez Showers got number 10 from Tyler Murphy because it was his grandmother's favorite number, and she was born on a 10 and died on 10. So there you go. All right, Francis, appreciate it very much. Francis Beer of the Gator Report. I want to thank Laurie Martin Gregory earlier today, our broadcast partner Tom Schmitz, of course, the indomitable guy behind the board, J.J. LaSalva. Much superior producer, and of course, Austin Statman Tap, my buddy Martin. Have a great night, everybody.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me and JJ LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
Having the motivation and making the commitment to quit smoking is a great first step towards becoming smoke-free. However, anyone who's tried to quit smoking knows how challenging it can be. Having the determination to quit may not be enough. You may need some help. If you're ready to quit smoking and are between the ages of 18 and 75, currently smoke 10 or more cigarettes a day, and can commit to participating for 24 weeks, you may be interested in a research study which is being conducted to evaluate the use of investigational drugs to see if they can aid individuals in their quest to quit smoking. To help you quit, smoking cessation counseling and all study-related medical care will be provided at no extra cost. You may also be reimbursed for your travel time. To receive more information about this study, how you can participate, please call Renstar Medical Research in Ocala at 352-629-5800. That's Renstar Medical Research in Ocala, 352-629-5800.
I'm
the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. Peter J. McAllister. He's a professor of neurology at Yale University School of Medicine, coming up to speak to us about treatment options that can help those with chronic migraines.
Susanna DeBaca is the Vice President of Wealth Strategies. She'll be speaking about the new City Pulse Index Survey.
And then News Bites. We take the hottest, freshest news right off the press, and we deliver it to you bite-sized.
Have all of your gardening questions answered by Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin on You've Got a Garden.
And then Tamiko Richardson will be on with us. She is a consultant to Team Disney, coming out to speak about a book called Get a Clue.
And then Joe Reichel from Damage Control will be answering all of your disaster restoration questions.
And Tim Prosh will be with us. He writes for the Wall Street Journal. He's got a book. It's called The Other Talk.
C. William Jones is the chairman of ProtectSeniors.org. He'll be speaking about IBM's cancellation of earned retirement health care benefits.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
So what did you do with your weekend? Me? I was flying, because I'm taking flying lessons from Ocala Aviation. Now you're probably thinking to yourself, hey, I'd like to give that a shot, but I'm not quite sure. Well, I've got the solution. It's called the Discovery Flight, and that's exactly what it is. It helps you discover the wonder of flying and if it's for you. It's only $99, and it gives you the chance to learn a bit more about the airplane and then actually go for a ride with a flight instructor and take control of the airplane. That's how I got started, and now I'm on my way to being a pilot. Yeah, I know, scary thought, right? But the demand for qualified pilots is stronger than ever. And with the help of Ocala Aviation, you could make a career change and learn to be a commercial pilot. But it all starts with a discovery flight. So stop by the flight school, conveniently located at the Ocala Airport. Visit the website at ocalaaviation.com or call 861-7484. That's 861-7484. Ocala Aviation. Your adventure starts here.
Call me crazy. Some people say insanity is doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. I think insanity is 1,000 single-sided, full-color business cards for $15 or packing service for 50% off. Call me crazy. Regency Printing, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street, 789-6683. That's 789-6683. Look for the yellow signs.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
ABC News Now, I'm Chuck Sievertson. A week after the former Navy reservist gunned down 12 workers at the Washington Navy Yard, Navy officials are moving to close gaps in the security clearance process. All police reports must be included when a background check is done, and Aaron Alexis had several involving shootings. A third day into the Islamist terrorist siege in an upscale shopping mall in Nairobi, Kenya's Defense Forces just tweeted they are in charge. They have made 10 arrests, are clearing the building. There's unexplained black smoke coming from the mall. At least 62 deaths plus 6 terrorists killed. Apple says the opening weekend sales of its new iPhone models totaled 9 million units, better than the iPhone 5, which last year sold 5 million its opening weekend. Saying federal flood relief money won't be affected by a possible government shutdown next week, Vice President Biden touring the damage, reaching settlements with 19 companies responsible for posting bogus online reviews, products and services, New York State's Attorney General. This is ABC News.
They call me Murphy, and I'm a service tech at Quick Lane Tire and Auto Center. It was 9:30 on a Saturday morning, and a Kona Blue Mustang drove in.
I'm due for a tire rotation. Overdue, I'm sure.
Well, better late than never. I poured her a cup of coffee, black.
Hey, can I hop on Wi-Fi?
Sure thing, no charge. She checked her emails and I checked the tires. Pressure was low in one.
Is it bad?
It's below the manufacturer's recommendation. Could affect your fuel economy. I properly inflated the tires, then rotated and aligned them. Did our quick lane multi-point inspection, too. Looked good. Took about a half hour, tops. Well, you're all set.
Thanks for fitting me in.
We always do. A quick lane tech is always ready to serve.
Get extraordinary service for routine maintenance at Quick Lane Tire and Auto Center. With a full range of services, great prices on 13 name brand tires, and no appointment necessary. Quick Lane is ready to serve. Visit quicklane.com.
Hey, I didn't know it rained last night.
Oh, it didn't. Why do you say that?
Because little Johnny's in the backyard playing in that big mud puddle.
Did you leave the hose on?
No, the neighbor borrowed it yesterday.
Wait, is that the side where the septic...
Johnny, get out of there!
Having septic problems? At Mike Scott Plumbing, we can make those septic worries disappear. We can pump your septic tank, repair your drain field, and, if needed, even install a whole new system. At Mike Scott Plumbing, we don't take crap from anyone. We take it from everyone. 237-2888. Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
You've Got a Garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is once again that time of year to vote for Ocala Magazine's Best of the Best. Each year, you have the power to go online and vote for your favorite chef, restaurant, hotel, and of course, your favorite radio show. So go online to OcalaMagazine.com and vote for Larry and Robin in the morning on WOCA, The Source.
Jacob, you forgot the voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
Ah, yes, of course. Then also vote for the voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
No, Jacob, they can't vote for both.
Well, that does present a problem. How do they decide?
I don't really care, just as long as they vote.
Are you always like this?
Like what?
So charming and friendly.
Oh, then yes, I am. Now wrap it up already.
Okay then, to recap, go to OcalaMagazine.com and vote for anyone you want, as long as it's Larry and Robin in the morning or the voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin on WOCA, The Source. How's that?
It'll do.
Howdy folks, RL here to invite you to Dairy Queen for a great new meal. Dairy Queen's now serving three different $5 meals. Hot dogs, chili, cheese, slaw, whatever. Quarter pound with cheese, loaded up any way you like it. Solid filet chicken tenders. And each meal comes with fries, a drink, and a sundae for only $5. You got that right. Nobody beats that deal. A great value and a great meal. So come on down to Dairy Queen at Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
WOCA.
He's America's consumer warrior, teaching you to save more, spend less, and avoid getting ripped off. He's Clark Howard.
Welcome to the Clark Howard Show, where it's all about you and your wallet. I want you to learn ideas from me that'll help you save more, spend less, and not get ripped off. Speaking of ripoffs, coming up in just a few moments in today's Clarkrageous Moment. People parading around the country, masquerading, lying, saying they're fee-only planners, smiling at you, picking your pocket, while you think they're looking out for you, they're looking out for their commissions. How to tell the difference. And later this hour, wow, what an industry. The car rental industry has come up with new strategies to take advantage of you when you rent a car. I'm going to tell you something. Gosh, it's more like a Clarkrageous moment, but a special warning for you coming a half hour from now. But right now, I want to talk about something California is up to that is a very, very nice move to protect children from the excesses and lack of judgment of youth. And if I didn't say so, our number for your calls, 877-87-CLARK. Here's what California has done. Pending the governor's signature, or the governor allowing this to become law without his signature, the state of California now will have an eraser statute. An eraser statute is something that's been talked about for several years, but has only been talk till now. All right, so here's the deal. When kids are young, adventurous, and kind of clueless, they're running around with phones and at a younger age, like iPod touches, and they're taking outrageous pictures and they're documenting things and doing things that on reflection, with a little more maturity, look like a really bad idea, right? It's happening a lot where kids that are applying to colleges end up based on what a school may find on social media or what they might find in a Google search or whatever. They decide a perfectly qualified candidate incoming. Employers looking at some of the youthful indiscretions that show up on the web or choosing not to extend an offer for a job to someone who is a perfectly qualified and capable candidate. So what California has with what's known as the eraser law is the ability for someone, when they reach adulthood, to go back and erase digital history from when they're a child. This is something that Facebook and Twitter already have put in place, and a lot of the elements of the law are based on Facebook and Twitter responding to the criticism involved with youthful indiscretions hanging there forever. Now, if somebody does something that is really outrageous, caught on video, caught on a picture, and it goes viral on the internet, you can't put that genie back in the bottle. But stuff that's confined to your own social media outlets that you participate in, you will have the ability, as a child who goes from immature to hopefully more mature as an adult, to say, oops, oops, I need to turn back the clock and erase some things that I shouldn't have been up to. And my oldest daughter really didn't take it seriously when I used to talk to her about this when she was a mid-teen, and something called MySpace, if you've heard of that, used to be a really big thing. Does that even exist anymore? It was so huge at one time. Anyway, Facebook essentially demolished it. And so I would talk to her about that, and she would just like zone out, or dad, you don't know what you're talking about. And it's funny how she will tell you by her own admission that somehow my IQ has gotten a lot better as she is an adult now. But it's hard when you're an exuberant kid to really understand how things have changed, that the web provides this like digital signature that follows you that didn't exist when kids would be kids. So California's statute may be one thing. More important is the statute in your own home and what you do as a parent to set out rules for your kid, and having not a conversation but multiple conversations. And one thing is to follow your child with his or her activities online and require that, because it's a privilege for you to allow a kid to do things on the web that are social in nature and on a phone, because you're the one who decided they got to have a phone, that they know that the deal is you're watching them. And they have to give permission for you to trail them wherever they go, whatever they do. And every kid is different. There are kids that you're not going to have to follow that closely, but there are times you're going to be fooling yourself. And regardless, it makes sense for you to monitor what activities they're engaged in online. And as I mentioned at the top, for preteens, the iPod Touch has, for many kids, become a touch too much freedom. And so you as a parent need to be on your game. Maybe when a kid is at age 8, 9, or 10, when you decide they can have their first iPod Touch. Our number, 877-87-CLARK. Robin is with us on the Clark Howard Show. Hello, Robin.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm doing wonderful. Thank you for taking my call.
My pleasure. How can I serve you?
Well, I'm single and I have three teenagers, and I've just been contacted through a company that I've been with for quite a while that they're starting a life insurance program. Is that something that I still need to look at as my children get older, for myself?
Life insurance for you with three teenagers would be a very valuable thing for you to have, because if you were to die prematurely and you've got three teenagers, what happens to them?
Right.
And so that creates a great value for something known as level term insurance, which probably was not in the pitch you received, because agents don't like to sell it.
Okay.
But what level term is it only pays a death benefit.
Okay.
In the event of your untimely demise. And you can buy it for different time periods. How old's your youngest?
13.
All right. So a 10-year level term policy would get all three of your teenagers into adulthood.
Right.
Where you buy, and you can buy a lot of coverage for very, very little money. Okay. Is your health good?
Yes, excellent.
Okay, so with good health, you know, you probably can hopefully fly through a medical underwriting screening. You're looking at tiny, tiny amounts of money for big coverage for a 10-year window where the premium stays the same over a 10-year period.
Okay, great.
And so when you go shopping, let me tell you how you can do that. You can shop online, and if you even just put in on a search engine like Google or Bing or DuckDuckGo, you just put in 10-year level term insurance, you'll be hit back with more websites than you knew existed. You get a sense of what you would be paying in premiums based on your age and however much coverage you want to buy. And with kids that are minors, normally what you would do is you would have the insurance in a simple trust with a trustee. Is there somebody who you would really trust to look out for the interests of your kids?
Absolutely.
If there is, then you name that person as potentially the trustee for the life insurance policy.
Okay.
For the benefit of your three kids. You know, this is a circumstance that the odds are so low that someone in good health at a young age is going to pass away in a 10-year period, that's why the premiums are so, so cheap.
Okay.
Because for the insurance industry, the risk of payout is teensy tiny. But if you were the unfortunate one who did die very young, you would know that your kids would be okay. You'd have peace of mind about that.
Great. That's what I needed to know.
Okay. Best of luck to you. And Rico is with us on the Clark Howard Show. Not quite. What happened to Rico here? We're going to do an Ask Clark. I'm sorry. Hi, Joel.
Yeah, Clark, we got a question from Sandra, who says, my mother, she's 79 years old. She still drives an 03 Ford. She'd like to know if she can discontinue her full coverage car insurance and get only liability.
Yes. Yes, on a car that is now, gosh, we're at the 14 model year now. And so an 11-year-old car, absolutely, positively, you would want to ditch collision and comprehensive on an 11-year-old car. As a practical rule, in that case, it's really easy for me to answer that. But in the case of an 11-year-old car, simple, a lot of times it's not as easy. So here's what you do. You figure out what the value of your car is today. You can go to Edmunds.com, E-D-M-U-N-D-S.com, or Kelley Blue Book, which is abbreviated on the web at KBB.com. And you can determine ballpark relative value of your vehicle as it gets some years on it. And usually you start hitting about the seventh year. A lot of cars will pass this test. And here's the test. If the cost of collision and comprehensive for your auto insurance for that car for a year exceeds 10% of the remaining value of the vehicle, you're generally better off dumping collision and comprehensive and being your own insurance company in the event you do have an accident. It does mean, if you follow my advice, let's say your car is still worth $4,500, you've essentially created a $4,500 deductible in your life if your car was to be totaled, stolen and not recovered, whatever. Now, coming straight ahead on the Clark Howard Show, I want to tell you how to avoid getting ripped off planning for your future.
Police called and broke the bad news to Charles. His personal and financial information was found on an identity thief's computer disk. Nervous and confused, Charles called LifeLock, the industry leader in identity theft protection. LifeLock went into action, uncovering multiple fraudulent credit applications the identity thief was trying to open in his name. LifeLock shut them down and helped him restore his good name and credit. Charles found out the hard way that identity theft is a global crime, a crime that's become so complex, you simply can't fight it alone. Your personal and financial information is everywhere. Don't wait for a call from the police before you take action. Visit LifeLock.com now or call and mention promo code AWARE to get a special 10% discount. Call 1-800-495-8010. 800-495-8010. 800-495-8010. See LifeLock.com for details. Network does not cover all transactions and scope may vary.
Jay Farner here with Quicken Loans. Here are two simple words that should make you reconsider waiting to buy a home. Buying power. Let's say you can afford a monthly mortgage payment, including principal and interest, of around $1,350. With today's rate on a 30-year fixed mortgage of 4.5%, APR 4.53%, that payment could support a $265,000 mortgage. But if you wait and rates tick up to around 6%, that same $1,350 mortgage payment, including principal and interest, may only be able to support a $215,000 mortgage. That's $50,000 worth of home that you're missing out on by waiting. That's buying power. And for 3 years in a row now, J.D. Power & Associates has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction for primary mortgage origination. Give Quicken Loans a call today at 800-QUICKEN or go to quickenloans.com and maximize your buying power.
For J.D. Power & Associates award information, visit jdpower.com. Payment example excludes taxes and insurance calls. For cost information, equal housing lender, license in all 50 states, NMLS number 3030.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. Peter J. McAllister. He's a professor of neurology at Yale University School of Medicine, coming up to speak to us about treatment options that can help those with chronic migraines.
Susanna DeBacca is the Vice President of Wealth Strategy. She'll be speaking about the new City Pulse Index Survey.
And then News Bites. We take the hottest, freshest news right off the press, and we deliver it to you bite-sized.
Have all of your gardening questions answered by Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin on You've Got a Garden.
And then Tamiko Richardson will be on on with us. She is a consultant to Team Disney, coming out to speak about a book called Get a Clue.
And then Joe Reichel from Damage Control will be answering all of your disaster restoration questions.
And Tim Prosh will be with us. He writes for the Wall Street Journal. He's got a book. It's called The Other Talk.
C. William Jones is the chairman of ProtectSeniors.org. He'll be speaking about IBM's cancellation of earned retirement health care benefits.
All of that plus fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Hurricane season is upon us. WOCA and Sunbelt Rentals wants you to be prepared. Sunbelt Rentals has the equipment to help, like air nailers, aerial lifts, chainsaws, chippers, and stump grinders. They have light towers, skid steer loaders, and generators, just to name a few. Sometimes you might need a little help cleaning up afterwards. Sunbelt has the equipment you need, like dehumidifiers, pumps, sewer snakes, wet dry vacs, floor dryers, carpet equipment, and more. And right now is the time to get it done, with two special offers just for WOCA listeners. If you rent Friday after 3 p.m. and return it Monday before 9 a.m., you will only be charged for one day. Plus, just by mentioning WOCA, you get 25% off your rental. You heard right, not 5 or 10, but 25% off your rental just by mentioning that you heard it here on WOCA. But you'd better hurry, this is a limited time offer. Visit Sunbelt today on Highway 27, just half mile east of I-75. Give them a call at 369-9101 or visit them on the web, sunbelt.com.
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the Links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Our number on the Clark Howard Show, 877-87-CLARK. I am very, very concerned about a report by financial writer Jason Zweig that there are a huge number of people in the stock brokerage industry and insurance industry masquerading as fee-only financial planners, conning you into thinking that they're looking out for you. I have a special consumer alert in today's Clarkrageous Moment.
Scams, ripoffs, outrages. It's a Clarkrageous Moment.
This is very upsetting. Okay, first of all, there's been a long time fight concerning insurance companies and stockbrokers where they've used their political influence in Washington to prevent being designated as what's known as fiduciaries. Insurance agents and stockbrokers working at places like Merrill Lynch or big insurance companies, they're allowed, or even small ones, they're allowed to sell you something that, in my opinion, would be junk because they don't have to do what's best for you at all. They have a special exemption from being this word that's fiduciary. I mean, that sounds like such a garbage word. It's an important word because someone who's your fiduciary is working for you and they are duty bound, legally obligated to do what's best for you. Well, more and more people across America have learned that you want to be with somebody who's on your team. And that's why the fastest growing part of giving people financial advice is what's known as fee only, where someone cannot receive commissions for anything they would advise or recommend so that you know they're working for you. So as people will ask somebody, well, are you fee only? Turns out, according to Zweig, that huge numbers of people are lying and saying that they are fee only when they're actually picking your pocket. All the big firms came up in this. Morgan Stanley, Chase Bank, Bank of America, Merrill Lynch, Wells Fargo, Ameriprise. Over and over again, they had people that worked for them claiming they were fee only when absolutely positively they are not. Same stuff in the insurance business. This is absolutely Clarkrageous. You know, if these people really want to do right by you, they won't work for one of these full commission stock brokerage houses that get up in the morning trying to figure out how they're going to take the most money from you and line their pockets with the most money to your great disadvantage. It has been a long historical problem. There was a news item that ran in the last few days. There's been big push to force stockbrokers and insurance agents to meet at least the fiduciary standard where they can't do something specifically to hurt you. And a lot of rumors in Washington that there's not going to be a change in what's known as the Merrill Lynch rule, which is this rule where Merrill Lynch used its political influence in Washington to get this in place in the first place, where they can work against you. They can work to your great harm and to line their pockets with your money. So know this. Follow the guidelines I have at clarkhoward.com about how you find a fee-only financial planner, how you really find somebody who really is there working for you, not pretending, not a pretender. You want the real article, because paying for your future and your retirement, that's a real thing. You got to make sure you have somebody who's truly, really working for you, not against you. This is the Clark Howard Show.
People are always looking to invest in a good opportunity. So what if you could invest in the future of kids, like a stock? Not the kind of stock that's about making money, but a stock for social change called Better Futures. With your investment, it helps students like me go to college. My name is Charles, and I'm your dividend.
Invest in better futures with UNCF. Visit uncf.org/invest. A mind is a terrible thing to waste, but a wonderful thing to invest in. Brought to you by UNCF and the Ad Council.
I'm Jim Cook here at our Sam Adams Brewery, tasting this year's Sam Adams Oktoberfest. Hit it, boys! Who wants some fresh Oktoberfest? This year's Oktoberfest is rich with sweet flavors like caramel and toffee.
Mm, that is really good.
Those unique flavors come from the 5 roasted malts in Sam Adams Oktoberfest. Ah, delicious. We only brew Sam Adams Oktoberfest for 2 months, so grab one before it's too late.
Then I definitely want more October.
WOCA, News Talk 1370, where news talk is our business, and business is good.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Kenseth is 2 for 2, but object in his mirror may be closer than they appear. I'm Woody Kane. The story next on NASCAR Today.
If you're a responsible homeowner who's faithfully made your mortgage payments, you deserve thanks for doing the right thing. And I'd like to tell you about a powerful financial tool that rewards your responsibility. Hi, I'm Jay Farner, president of Quicken Loans. And the tool that I'm talking about is the Home Affordable Refinance Program, or HARP. HARP is designed to help you lower your mortgage payments. It's for responsible homeowners who are current on their payments, but due to the housing market, may have little or no equity left in their home. And even if you were unable to get a HARP loan in the past, new guidelines mean that now you may be eligible. Over 2.5 million homeowners have already taken advantage of HARP and are saving an average of $250 a month. If you're one of the millions yet to take advantage, call us today at 800-QUICKEN. To learn more, call Quicken Loans today at 800-QUICKEN or go to quickenloans.com.
That number again is 800-QUICKEN.
Important terms and conditions apply. Call us for cost information. Equal housing lender. Licensed in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
Even though he's won the first two races in the chase for the Sprint Cup, Matt Kenseth knows he can't ease off after winning yesterday at New Hampshire.
My outlook's really not any different or approach, honestly. I know it's kind of cliche, but I mean, it really is one week at a time, especially right now. Now, you know, if you get down toward the end and you're lucky enough to have a lead or something, maybe you start looking at that more, thinking about it more. But man, two whole months and 8 weeks of racing is a lot of racing. And, in this system, it doesn't, one bad finish and you're behind.
Kenseth now leads teammate Kyle Busch by just 14 points since he's finished second to Matt the last 2 weeks.
I don't think you do anything differently than you've done all year long. You know, I think the organization's going to give the equipment to the both of us. I don't think any one of us is going to get better stuff. So it's just going to come down to better communication between myself and the crew chief and that way, because it doesn't matter if it's your teammate or anybody else. You still got to work hard and persevere. It's 8 more weeks.
The championship battle heads to Dover this weekend. Jeff Burton had a solid run Sunday as well, finishing 8th after earlier saying he won't be back in the 31 car at Richard Childress Racing next year. Today on MRN Motorsports Monday, he said he's close to a decision about next year.
You know, a month ago or so when all these conversations started, you know, one thing I told my wife is that I wasn't going to panic about it. I was going to kind of let things happen. I wasn't going to push anything. I was just kind of let them happen. And then as it became clear to me what I wanted to do, then I was going to push. So, you know, I'm still a couple weeks away probably from really, really having a decision made. But I've got some really, really fun opportunities ahead of me. And we'll just have to see which one I choose.
For more, visit the new MRN.com. I'm Woody Kane. This is NASCAR Today on the Motor Racing Network.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
If you get a migraine, try to hug your family more often or your pets. The chemical oxytocin, which is released when we hug a loved one, it can cut the intensity of a migraine headache in half. Today, a lot of people think that flirting via text message is as bad as cheating in real life. Comedies may get us laughing and help us forget our pain for a few minutes, but sad songs and movies actually help us get over the pain much quicker.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Don't ever miss a single edition of the Mike Huckabee Show. We're going to have a whole lot of fun talking the big issues of the day. We'll talk to the newsmakers and the issues that made them a newsmaker, as well as we'll bring you some entertainment, some fun. You never know what's going to happen on the Mike Huckabee Show. Don't miss it.
Join Mike Huckabee every weekday from noon to 3, exclusively on WOCA The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. We're in Florida. Clouds and some sunshine today with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm around, particularly during the afternoon hours, high 84 to 88. It'll be mostly cloudy tonight with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm, low 72 to 76. Tomorrow and Wednesday will be rather cloudy with rain at times along with a thunderstorm or two, high both days between 84 and 88. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, this is Joe, and I'm your host for the new show, Damage Control, every Tuesday morning at 10:30 a.m., brought to you by Damage Control Services. We're going to be discussing floods, fires, storm and tree damage, sinkholes, mold, and many other disasters that you need to know about, how to prevent and prepare for them, as well as what to do when it happens and what to expect after it happens. This is Damage Control, Tuesdays at 10:30, right here on The Source.
WOCA, Ocala. All across the USA.
Welcome to the Clark Howard Show, where it's all about your wallet. I want you to learn ways from me to save more, spend less, and not get ripped off. Our number, 877-87-CLARK on the web. We serve you at clarkhoward.com. If you go to clarkhoward.com/book, you can learn all about my newest book, my 10th, Clark Howard's Living Large for the Long Haul. I want to tell you about something that I've had more and more experience with. I had it a lot on book tour. That I've been on the road through the summer, and I'll be doing more stops in the fall, and I rent cars everywhere I go. And I've had experiences now that I've not experienced in the past where with the fuel for the vehicle, I'm being told I need to bring back a receipt. I had one spot that told me, one car rental that said, if your gas receipt is for a station more than 5 miles from the airport, you're going to be penalized for having filled up more than 5 miles away. And, you know, the gauge reading and all that is normally all you have to worry about. Well, now Avis is implementing a system where they are now charging you based on tenths of a gallon. They use a technology that can read the amount of gas in the tank down to a tenth of a gallon. And if you return it with anything less than what you went out with, they will charge you per tenth of a gallon at just under a dollar per tenth. Now, the average price of gasoline around the country now is most places $3 and change, but they're charging a dollar per tenth of the equivalent of almost $10 a gallon by how they're computing it for each fraction of a gallon they say you have not returned it with. So they're not alone. The Washington Post reports that Hertz is going to go to this similar kind of system, but theirs will do even more. Theirs will be able to shut down your car rental by remote control if there's some reason they're unhappy with you. They will also, on the plus side, be able, as they implement this through their fleet, if you lock yourself out of the car, they'll be able to unlock it for you remotely. That would be nice. But the idea of electronic fuel metering is really a nitpicky kind of thing. The idea of full out and full back in seems reasonable to me. Yes, there are times that I leave a rental plaza with a car and it's showing on full and I get just a little down the road and it comes pretty far down, which means somebody did fill the car up, but maybe pretty far from the airport before they returned it. What I can tell you this means, because you never want to accept any of the rip-off fuel options that a car rental company offers you, where they say, oh, we will sell you fuel in advance, and you can just bring the car back empty, blah, blah, blah. It's a complete rip. But what I can recommend to you is that when you do fill up a car before you return it, which you want to do, because otherwise you are paying typically close to $10 a gallon or more. If you don't fill it up, that's what they'll charge you, is that you do what environmentalists don't want you to do, which is when the gas clicks off at a station, that you top it off. That's the only way I can tell you for sure that in the case of an Avis car and soon a Hertz car, they're not going to rip you off. This Washington Post story gives examples of people who filled cars up, getting their wallets just eaten up with junk fees that they were billed later. And I brought this up in our pre-show staff meeting, and three people at the conference table in our staff meeting all talked about experiences they had had recently where they were charged money for fuel on tanks they had returned full to the car rental company. So this is the next area where they're going to try to bleed your wallet. You need to be prepared. Our number is 877-87-CLARK. Gordon is with us on the Clark Howard Show. Hello, Gordon.
How you doing?
Great. Thank you, Gordon. You have a question for me as a fellow lover of NFL football.
Yes, I got two things to tell you, two things how you and your your listeners could save money. First, the NFL ticket, Sunday ticket, I found a way to get the NFL Sunday ticket online without a DirecTV subscription.
And yeah, share this with your fellow listener, because it's a really neat thing. Because NFL ticket normally, is it $300 a season?
Yes, it is. It's $300 right now. If you want to watch it on DirecTV or online. but there's a way to watch it online. And what you do is basically you pay. You go to if you go to Amazon.com, Madden. If you click on Madden NFL 25th Anniversary Edition, DirecTV and EA Sports has a. It's going to include NFL Sunday Ticket if you buy the game for $99, and you get the NFL Sunday Ticket for free on the computer.
Well, I've ordered mine for $99.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, and I ordered the one for the Xbox 360. I think they have the promotion with different things.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to end up being a gift for somebody, you know, the game, because I don't play video games. But it's so neat because I'll be able to watch, if it works out like they say it will, I'll be able to watch my NFL Sunday Ticket. I say my NFL Sunday Ticket. Like,
yeah.
It's mine. But I'll be able to watch it on tablets and laptops and all that, right?
That's right.
Do you have people should know?
I'm sorry?
Any gotchas that people should know?
The only thing I would just double check, you know, do you the diligence and make sure, you know, it's the $99 and to make sure it says includes NFL Sunday Ticket, and it's really easy. And what you do is once you get the game and get the promotion, they give you a password and username and a password, and you go to directtv.com/EA special, and then you click start watching, and then you put in the username and your password, and you get to watch it for free on the computer.
It is so great.
And
you know, one thing I'll tell you on message boards is that people have bought the new Google device that, what do they call that thing? Chrome something that is $35.
Yes.
That plugs in Chromecast, that then you can be watching NFL Sunday Ticket over the web and it will play on your big screen television.
That's what I do. I watch it on my big screen TV. Also, you can watch it on your tablet and your mobile device.
Well,
so
see, I used to get NFL Sunday Ticket years ago, and I stopped doing it because I travel so much that out of a 17-week season, I was getting to watch, you know, maybe 2 weeks of it. And so
right.
I thought, this is a lot of money
for
2 weeks of football. And it's true. NFL football is, that's the only thing I care about being able to watch on a television, period.
Yes.
Nothing else matters to me on a TV. And so I've missed, like I was out of town this past weekend, and I missed several games I really would have wanted to see because I was able to watch just the two games that were playing locally in the city I was in, and
right.
I missed so much fun in the NFL this past weekend. So
a
question for you, how many games can you keep up with at once on Sunday Ticket?
To tell you the truth, my father and I are Eagles fans, so we just watch the Eagles game, and then once that's over, we watch whatever we want, but we're diehard Eagle fans.
All right, that must have eaten you up. Was that this past Thursday that the Eagles lost to Kansas City?
I was at work, but I was listening to it on the radio online, and I was heartbroken. I was disappointed, but hopefully they'll come back strong next week.
Okay, so this is so funny. I was sure you were going to say you are a New England Patriots fan because you sound like you're right, like you live next door to the Patriots Stadium. Your accent.
I do. It's literally like 40 minutes away.
Well, the Eagles may not be their year.
Not this year, maybe.
No, we'll see. But the Patriots that you don't care about are undefeated. But all right, so for those of you who are not into football, let me tell you what the scoop is with NFL Sunday Ticket. It allows you to watch every NFL game from everywhere in the country, whenever it's on, wherever you are. And I'm able to watch 5 games at once and somehow keep up with what's going on in them. And when I watch a game, just one game, I'm like, this sure moves slowly. because I've gotten so used to overloading on it. Years ago, when I first got NFL Sunday Ticket, my father-in-law was over at the house watching football with me, and he left and went to his place because I was driving him crazy with the remote switching all the games. And now, thanks to the ability to be portable with it through the Amazon deal, again, you go to Amazon.com, the search term you do, and thanks, Gordon, for bringing this up. Search term you do is Madden NFL 25 Anniversary Edition with NFL Sunday Ticket. That is a mouthful. And then if it's available still, you'll be able to watch the remainder of the season. By the time you get it, you'll probably have 15 weeks left, 14 weeks left. But that's a lot of football to be able to watch for $99. Thanks, Gordon. And Mary Ann is with us on the Clark Howard Show. Hello, Mary Ann.
Hi, Clark.
Mary Ann, your husband's looking for a car.
That's correct, yes. We're out looking for to replace the car that he has now. And I was just wondering, in some of the dealerships, we see 2012 cars sitting there. They're new 2012s. And I was wondering, is that a good car to try to go after? And do you think I would be able to get a good deal on that, or is that something I should stay away from?
Yeah, anybody stuck with a 2012, I mean, think about, I just mentioned a few minutes ago, the 2014s and a lot of models are already out. So
right.
We're virtually at a point that that's two model years back. You'd have to get a giant discount from a 13 or potentially even a 14 to consider getting a 2012. But there's more you need to think about. Ready?
Okay, go ahead.
If you keep a car a long, long, long time, and you get a substantial discount buying one that's, let's call it 1.75 model years old at this point.
Mm-hmm.
And you keep a car 8, 10, 12 years, then you pick up the savings and you really keep it. On the other
right.
hand, if you tend to get vehicles every few years, it's almost like false savings buying one that would be nearly two model years old. So much value has been eaten up of the car that if you keep a car just a few years, you're not going to see any benefit of having done that.
Right. Well, we've always kept our cars at least 10 years.
If you keep a car 10 years and they're begging for you to take a 2012 off their lots, do it. But
well, actually,
I'd like you to go to a website for me. Do you go on the internet
okay.
at all?
Yeah, sure.
I'd like you to go to a website called TrueCar.com.
Right.
Have you been to TrueCar?
Yes, I have in the past.
If you go to TrueCar, price what they show of the model you're interested in, what they show you should be paying for a 2012, and then in turn what you'd pay for a 2013. If they already have the 2014s for the model you're interested in posted, what it would be for a 2014. Look at the price differences based on, because TrueCar has very thorough information on where prices are right now in the marketplace
okay.
for any new car, really. You'll
okay.
be able to see if it really is worth it for you to go back a model year or two.
Okay, so even the 2012s, the numbers that they give you on TrueCar, that would be, a legitimate number to be looking at?
Yes.
Okay.
Because if they
All
still
right.
show 2012s new in their database.
Right, okay. All right, so then I guess if we're going to keep it, which we normally do, like I said, that would be something to look at as long as they're willing to give us a good discount on it.
It's got to be a substantial discount from the 13s and 14s.
Right, because when I had first mentioned it to one of the salesmen on the dealership lot, he kind of almost steered us away. He really didn't even want to talk about the 12s. But, you know, when I look at them and the prices are so high, I go, well, if we could save a decent amount of money on the 12 and it's new, you know, it might be worth it to look at it. But I have to go back and talk to them again, I guess.
Yeah, and I don't want you talking to the dealer till it's time to take delivery. I want you doing your shopping from the comfort of your own home.
Do it over the internet.
Yep, you'll pay a whole lot less money that way and a whole lot less hassle if you do all your work, true homework, from your home instead of on a dealer's lots. Remember, you're on their home field instead of your home field. You're listening to the Clark Howard Show.
You've been lied to. Lied to by corrupt Washington politicians and the Wall Street propaganda machine. My name is Brett Kitchen, and I want to give you a free copy of my Inc. magazine best-selling book, Safe Money Millionaire, because according to Time magazine, Wall Street's retirement plans and 401ks have failed millions of Americans. After losing 35% in my IRA in the crash years ago, I said enough. And since then, I discovered a way to safely grow money up to 10 to even 15% during the good years, reduce taxes dramatically, and also have my money protected when the next stock market crash hits. Call now and talk with a specialist to discover this little-known strategy to build a tax-advantaged retirement income, get potential 10 to 15% growth during good years, and never lose in the next stock market crash. Call 800-342-4040 to discover this tool that people like Walt Disney and JCPenney use to safely grow rich. Plus, get one of just 97 free books left. We even cover shipping and handling. Call 800-342-4040. 1-800-342-4040. Again, that's 1-800-342-4040. 1-800-342-4040.
Julie, are you ready to go?
Almost. I just need to print these coupons.
Oh, shoot. We're out of ink again. Have you ever tried Cartridge World?
No, I buy my ink online. I'm always running out.
You've got to try Cartridge World. You'll save a ton on ink and toner, and they're on our way.
With 600 stores, Cartridge World is your local printing expert. You'll get fast and friendly service and save on ink and toner every day. Guaranteed. Find a store at cartridgeworld.com. That's cartridgeworld.com.
Dr. Forrest, dial 118.
A hospital ward, a manufacturing floor, a distribution center, or a retail store. At a firehouse, a courthouse, or a schoolhouse, Kronos is helping all types of organizations control their labor costs, improve workforce productivity, and minimize compliance risk. And that's leading to increased revenues, decreased costs, and creating happier patients, customers, and citizens. See how the Kronos Cloud can help your organization at Kronos.com. Kronos, workforce innovation that works.
On the next Voice of Ocala, it's Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. It's your chance to see how you fare against me, the Tribunator, and take a chance at winning great prizes from the historic Marion Theater, Mojo's Grill and Catering Company, Stone Creek Golf Club, and the Ocala Golf Club. Plus, it's Around the Water Cooler with Tom James, Buddy Martin, JJ LaSalva, and myself as we talk all the hot topics of today's sports world. All that and more on the next Voice of Ocala on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, The Source.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge, undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Ugh, what wrong?
Ugh, need wood for fire.
Ugh, I go get. Ugh, I got wood for fire.
Ugh, what takes so long?
Had to use restroom. Someone not refill toilet paper.
Ugh, my bad. You wash hands?
Ugh, of course. Ugh, what caveman you take me for?
You know, Dan, people who save money by switching to Mike Scott Plumbing sure are happy.
Well, Brittany, how happy are they?
Happier than a caveman with indoor plumbing.
Yep. Get happy. Get Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it. 237-2888.
Our number on the Clark Howard Show, 877-87-CLARK. Thomas is with us. Thomas, you want to share a story with your fellow listeners about selling a piano, is that right?
Yes, it is. Clark, it's a pleasure to talk to you. I listen to you frequently.
Well, I'm glad you do. Thank you.
I have a baby grand piano that my mother left me when she passed away.
Sorry, you lost
her,
Mom.
I've had it listed on a couple of different internet listing companies. Some couple of them paid, and the free service also. I was told not to use the names.
Oh, Craigslist?
Pardon?
Craigslist?
Yes.
Okay.
It's on Craigslist, and I have had numerous inquiries, maybe 15 to 18, and out of all those, only two were legit. And typically you get a response, and you can tell because they don't ask about the condition or any details about the piano, and they're all just concerned about how I'm going to get paid.
Right.
And many of them use, you know, they want to offer the online pay service that is supposedly very secure.
PayPal?
Yes, PayPal, yes.
Okay. Yeah,
and I'm just curious how they've
This is a morphing. I'm glad you're mentioning this because this is a morphing and an increase in sophistication of the scams that are proliferated on Craigslist, not Craigslist's fault, where criminals pretend that they are going to buy whatever it is from you. And ultimately what happens is somehow, oops, in whatever way they do, they're overpaying you. And you're supposed to send money back. Did you sell the piano to one of the two legitimate buyers?
No, not yet.
Not yet. But you have to waste so much time with the people who are pretending they're buyers that are just trying to steal. This is the Clark Howard Show.
Hi, this is Brad. I want to take a moment to talk about a serious issue. In the next 5 years, the aviation industry is projected to have a shortage of commercial pilots. Now is the time to start training. Ocala Flying Club has started a scholarship for the youth of Marion County ages 17 to 24. The club will donate up to $4,000 towards a pilot's license. This will help get the student on their way to obtain their commercial pilot license. If this sounds like something you would be interested in, or if you know someone that would be, please contact Ocala Aviation Services, 861-7484.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
News now. I'm Chuck Sievertson. More money in your pocket. Gasoline prices continue to fall. The Energy Department says the average price of a gallon of regular dropped 5 cents last week to $3.49. That's down 33 cents compared to the same week last year. 3 days after an Islamist terrorist attack at an upscale shopping mall in Kenya, packed with shoppers from the U.S. and elsewhere. Officials say they believe all hostages are released, soldiers and special forces combing the mall to see if any terrorists are left behind. At least 62 people are dead. That new iPhone model is sure popular, despite some analysts saying there aren't that many new features. Apple says it sold 9 million units last weekend, millions more than during the premiere of the iPhone 5 last year. A week after the Washington Navy Yard massacre, the Navy says that it's improving its background check system. Touring Colorado flood damage, Vice President Biden saying any government shutdown next week won't affect federal relief dollars. This is ABC News.
Oh, man, what is that smell?
Oh, I just opened the lettuce crisper.
We have a lettuce crisper? Everything gets old, even your shocks. So make sure you change your worn shocks at 50,000 miles.
What are you doing? Put the top back on!
I think it's moving.
Actual mileage may vary depending on driver ability, vehicle type, and the type of driving and road conditions. Purchase 4 qualifying Monroe shocks or struts between now and October 31st and get the price of the lowest cost unit back by mail-in offer. Restrictions apply. Learn more at Monroe.com.
Go on, sweetie. Jump to Dad.
I'm not sure, Daddy. The water's cool.
There are moments in life that cause us to hesitate.
Jump right here.
Okay. Here I come.
I got you. Good job.
I did it. That was fun.
But once we take action, we're really glad that we did. If you're thinking about selling your home, don't hesitate. Interest rates are low and buyers are in the market. Every market's different. Call a Realtor today and visit Realtor.com. Realtors are members of the National Association.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Gene Powell Pass Chemowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pass Chemowing, 352-629-2440, or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pass Chemowing.
Habitat for Humanity of Marion County is a ministry dedicated to improving lives by providing affordable and decent housing. Help them help others by visiting the Habitat for Humanity Ocala Home Store on Northwest 27th Avenue. To schedule a donation, give them a call and they'll come and pick it up. For more information, visit habitatocala.org. Habitat for Humanity of Marion County, building homes, building hope, building community.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
If you get a migraine, try to hug your family more often or your pets. The chemical oxytocin, which is released when we hug a loved one, it can cut the intensity of a migraine headache in half. Today, a lot of people think that flirting via text message is as bad as cheating in real life. Comedies may get us laughing and help us forget our pain for a few minutes, but sad songs and movies actually help us get over the pain much quicker.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Howdy folks, RL here to invite you to Dairy Queen for a great new meal. Dairy Queen's now serving three different $5 meals. Hot dogs, chili, cheese, slaw, whatever. Quarter pound with cheese, loaded up any way you like it. Solid filet chicken tenders. And each meal comes with fries, a drink, and a sundae for only $5. You got that right. Nobody beats that deal. A great value and a great meal. So come on down to Dairy Queen at Silver Springs, where they always treat you like kings and queens.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's OcalaForSale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less proofing factory surcharge or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
It's time to take charge of your wallet and your future. Missing a minute can cost you big time. Prepare to save more, spend less, and avoid getting ripped off with Clark Howard.
Welcome to the Clark Howard Show, where you're empowered with advice and info that you can put to work in your wallet so that you can save more, spend less and avoid getting ripped off. Our number, 877-87-CLARK. Info on the new book, Clark Howard's Living Large for the Long Haul, available at clarkhoward.com/book. Coming up a half hour from now, getting easier for you to buy cheaper transportation. I'm going to tell you about developments that will fatten your wallet, or at least keep it from shrinking so quickly. That's just a half hour from now for you on the Clark Howard Show. Right now, though, I want to talk about something that has become an issue in my household and many others, and it's how we're losing some of that intimacy as families because we're on our electronic gadgets. We're on them just way too much, and our kids potentially becoming zombies. Listen to this.
Some parents really struggle with, like, all the other kids have the terrible things, so my kid has to, yeah, let your kid go and be a better example. Just because the other stupid kids have phones doesn't mean that, okay, well, my kid has to be stupid, otherwise she'll feel weird. You know, I think these things are toxic, especially for kids. And right. They don't look at people when they talk to them, and they don't build the empathy. The thing is, you need to build an ability to just be yourself and not be doing something. That's what the phones are taking away.
Yes.
So we clean that up a little. There's a viral video version working its way around the web right now. And that was Louis C.K. on Conan O'Brien about how the cell phone thing is really starting to affect interpersonal, especially with kids, where they're losing the ability to look somebody in the eye and carry on a conversation. And it's true. So this morning, I was taking my son to school, and I realized that I had left my cell phone at home. And I was only, 30 seconds from the house. Do I turn around and go get my cell phone? I was going to be gone for hours from home. And I thought, you know what? If I go home for that, I'm the one on the leash, not it. And I went ahead and dropped my son off at school, went to a medical appointment, had an interview, and then get back home. And get my phone. I had 7 missed calls, lots of missed text messages, zillion emails. So what? It didn't matter. It did not matter. I mean, you know, there was nothing life and death other than my wife saying, why didn't you respond to my message? And I told her I'd forgotten my phone. She said, oh, okay. But the thing is that we do get too much into it. And there are times that we're sitting around at the house and all of us are on some kind of electronic gadget. And we're not communicating with each other except say, hey, have you seen this? So one of the ideas I saw, an item, I forget what newspaper I saw this in, but it was people talking about their strategies as a family. How do you get back that family time? I mean, you can say you're not going to let kids have gadgets anyway, or you can quarantine them. And people have routines where they'll take their phone when they come in the door from the car and they put it somewhere where they don't touch it till a certain time, like till after dinner. I believe in electronic curfews for kids, that they're off their gadgets at a time that you set. Most often, depending on the age of a kid, it'll be 8:30, 9 o'clock, something like that. And the most important thing is if you don't want to disrupt your sleep, do not sleep with your cell phone at your bedside. And people overwhelmingly do that. They plug it in right by their bedside, and it's the last thing they look at before they go to bed. It's the first thing they look at when they wake up. And if you're married or in a relationship, the person next to you should really be who's getting your attention last thing and first thing, not a little electronic thing. So think about ways you can set boundaries. And it's funny, I feel like cleansed that I was without my phone for a couple of hours. But my family challenged me and said they wanted to see me go a whole weekend without my phone. And I'm now going to accept that challenge. They had given it to me as a rhetorical one. I'm now going to accept it as a real thing and see what it's like going cell phone free for an entire weekend, which if you think about how silly that sounds, that would be like an accomplishment. But there's this psychological connection, some would say an addiction, to an electronic device like a cell phone that you don't want to rule your life. I don't want to rule mine. Our number, 877-87-CLARK. Gail is with us. Hello, Gail. Gail, welcome to the Clark Howard Show.
Well, hi, Clark. It's a pleasure to talk to you, and thank you for taking my call.
Certainly, Gail.
I have a question, a travel-related question, and I know that you've addressed similar ones before, but because it didn't directly affect us at that time, I don't have all the details written down. We have a 15-year-old daughter who has made friends with a girl from Madrid, Spain. The girl has traveled here for two summers in a row now and was an exchange student with us. We hosted her for the summers. And her family now wants our daughter to go there this coming summer. So it would be about a year from now. Our daughter
How
has never
fun.
Traveled. It does sound like fun, but our daughter has never traveled alone, even domestically. She will be paying for a good portion of the airfare herself and working and babysitting and things like that to earn it. And so her questions, and I guess I'm asking them on her behalf because she's in school right now, she's wanting to know when the best time to buy is, when the best time to go, which airline, if there are particular airlines she should be looking at, and even is there a better day of the week for her to be traveling on.
Yeah, all right, let me see if I can handle... Let me see if I can handle all those, if I remembered all those things. And then if you have other questions, we can go those. All right. So
perfect.
Day of the week, yes, airfares internationally tend to be lower Monday to Thursday, both directions.
Okay.
And lowest generally on Tuesday and Wednesday for leisure travelers.
Okay.
And as far as the best time, when does she get out of school?
She's out the very beginning of June.
Okay.
And then they do not go back until after Labor Day.
All right. And how long will she visit?
She's hoping to be there somewhere between 4 and 6 weeks.
All right. Now, it's not true every year, but often it is true that the airfares after June 16th are higher than they are June 1 to June 15th, which are also higher than they are in May. So the earlier she goes in June, the better, or going in August. The reason August is that a lot of school systems around the country go back to school as soon as August 1st now, but definitely the first week or so of August.
Okay.
So August used to be a peak month for summer travel, and now it's not anymore. Really,
perfect.
The peak is about June 16th through July 31st for airfares, especially to Europe. So often there will be deals for August travel that will make it a better deal than anything in June or July.
Perfect. Thank you.
So going when to buy. For travel, definitely in the month of June, about the middle of April is when you want to buy.
Okay.
When you start looking, though, at August, it's hard to say. I mean, deals could pop up in the April-May period, or it may even involve more nail-biting waiting for a while.
All right.
Makes you nervous, doesn't it?
It does. That's not the type of person she or we are.
Okay. Well, the airlines take advantage of that. The airlines know that a lot of people taking a big trip really want to lock things in early. And
okay.
So the early bird gets the worm. with the airline industry, the early bird gets the high fare.
Perfect. Good to know. Thank you.
Now the late bird pays the most. So it's kind of an in-between area where you get the best deals, usually about 45 days out. It's kind of a general rule for international when you get the best deals.
Okay.
That's general, not always. And where do you live in the country?
We're in Wisconsin.
Where in Wisconsin are you?
We are right near Eau Claire.
Okay, so that
would be
gives you
north central.
Right, so that gives you an option of traveling west to Minneapolis if there's a good deal out of Minneapolis.
Yes.
Gives you an option of going down to Chicago.
Absolutely.
And Chicago is where you're most likely to find the best deals that are going to be available for summer to Spain.
Okay. Very good. Thank you. I guess two other quick questions.
Yes.
Any recommendations for an under 16-year-old traveling alone? Are there any special things we should be doing or looking for?
Well, one thing you can do is you can use it as an excuse to go with her, get her settled there, and then you have to put up with suffering traveling in Europe, and then you won't be so nervous as I hear in your voice.
I will tell my husband that.
I mean, that's the best excuse for you to go take a really neat trip.
Sounds great. But I will tell my husband that and make it be your idea.
But if that's not going to be realistic, she'll be fine. She really will. And even if she has to do a plane change going to visit the family in Spain, she'll be fine. 15-year-olds do it all the time.
Sounds good. And are there any particular sites we should be looking on to track these airfares as it gets closer to April?
Yes, two in particular that I'd like for you to look at for shopping internationally. Mobissimo. M is in Mary, O-B-I-S-S-I-M-O, mobissimo.com.
Okay.
And the other is Kayak, K-A-Y-A-K.com.
Okay. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
I hope she has a great, great time. And really, steal that idea of going along as well. You deposit her with the exchange student's family, and then you and your husband go sightseeing.
I love it. Thank you so much.
Sure. So you'll be doing part-time jobs, too, to come up with the money, right, Gail? But I'm telling you, you'll love it. You're listening to The Clark Howard Show.
Jay Farner here with Quicken Loans. Here are two simple words that should make you reconsider waiting to buy a home. Buying power. Let's say you can afford a monthly mortgage payment, including principal and interest, of around $1,350. With today's rate on a 30-year fixed mortgage of 4.5%, APR 4.53%, that payment could support a $265,000 mortgage. But if you wait and rates tick up to around 6%, that same $1,350 mortgage payment, including principal and interest, may only be able to support a $215,000 mortgage. That's $50,000 worth of home that you're missing out on by waiting. That's buying power. And for 3 years in a row now, J.D. Power & Associates has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction for primary mortgage origination. Give Quicken Loans a call today at 800-QUICKEN or go to quickenloans.com and maximize your buying power.
For J.D. Power & Associates award information, visit jdpower.com. Payment example excludes taxes and insurance. Calls for cost information. Equal housing lender license in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
For the careful investor, these are challenging times. Thankfully, there's Assured Guarantee. When you invest in municipal bonds insured by Assured Guarantee, every dime of principal and interest is guaranteed. Backed by a quarter century of experience and $12 billion in claims-paying resources, ask your financial advisor about Assured Guarantee, the proven leader in municipal bond insurance, for investors who embrace possibilities but invest in certainties.
Sometimes it feels like you'll never find the one God intended for you.
But that person is out there, and ChristianMingle.com can help you find her.
And it's amazing what blessings can follow.
We were married in 2011, and our son was born the next April. If it weren't for ChristianMingle.com, we wouldn't have this beautiful family.
I want to fall in love with you.
Find God's match for you, the way we did.
Join ChristianMingle.com today. Joining is easy and free.
News Talk 1370, WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000, 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370, WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the Links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Don't ever miss a single edition of the Mike Huckabee Show. We're going to have a whole lot of fun talking the big issues of the day. We'll talk to the newsmakers and the issues that made them a newsmaker, as well as we'll bring you some entertainment, some fun. You never know what's going to happen on the Mike Huckabee Show. Don't miss it.
Join Mike Huckabee every weekday from noon to 3, exclusively on WOCA The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. We're in Florida. Clouds and some sunshine today with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm around, particularly during the afternoon hours, high 84 to 88. It'll be mostly cloudy tonight with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm, low 72 to 76. Tomorrow and Wednesday will be rather cloudy with rain at times along with a thunderstorm or two, high both days between 84 and 88. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
WOCA, keeping you in touch with Ocala.
Our number on the Clark Howard Show, 877-87-CLARK. And Tim, you are an entrepreneur, is that right? Tim?
Yes.
You're an entrepreneur. You want to start your own business.
I certainly do, Clark, and thank you very much for taking my call.
Sure. Well, I'm thrilled because, you know, the lifeblood of our economic system is based on people who have the guts to go out and start their own businesses. What are you thinking of doing? How can I be of help?
I am thinking of producing a product. I want to go into manufacturing and into apparel. But I need some direction. I have located a website address that I would like, a company logo, and I've begun my business plan. But now I need some direction with regard to where do I go? Do I incorporate first? Do I get my logo finished and attach that to my paperwork? I'm not clear on how I should proceed from here.
Okay, so first, finish your business plan.
Okay.
Second, how much money is it going to take you to launch your business?
Quite a bit.
We talking millions, thousands, hundreds of thousands?
I would say hundreds of thousands.
Okay. And how are you going to fund that?
Investors.
And are they already identified? Are you going to seek investors?
Two are identified, and I will seek some additional investors.
Okay. So... if you already have people that are that trust you, believe in you, and maybe part of the crowd you need to write big checks,
mm-hmm.
have you identified a CPA, an accountant yet that will assist you with your business?
No, I have not.
Okay. I would say that comes before the issue of incorporation.
Okay.
Because there are a number of things that they'll suggest to you as the right way for you to proceed based on the way they look at numbers as a structure, since you'll have a number of investors. Will you have fewer than 10 investors? Is that what you're thinking?
Yes. The goal would be fewer than 10.
Okay.
Fewer
than so that five. becomes part of the puzzle.
Okay.
So I would go sit down with a CPA, and you want to have a CPA who will work with you with your business from its infancy forward.
Okay.
And you also want to have a lawyer who is somebody who just doesn't do a one-time thing with you. If you're going to have a bunch of outside investors, you're going to need the services of that lawyer going forward.
Okay.
And I can tell you that the CPA you work with may, in fact, be able to guide you to a lawyer who he or she has known from other businesses, maybe even startups. There would be somebody good for you to talk to figure out whether you're best off being some form of partnership, limited liability company, or a traditional corporation.
Yeah, that would be one of my questions, yes.
And so a CPA in tandem with a lawyer is the right combo. But it's not just any old lawyer, and it's not a question I could easily answer.
Okay.
And, you know, one thing you benefit from as you start up is today with the internet, you can actually get logos done much cheaper than the past. I've got some stuff about that on ClarkHoward.com. A lot of the services you need in the initial phase of startup, the internet has made easier for you to...